Citizens Radio Station, News Radio 620, WTMJ, Milwaukee.
I'm Greg Nancik in for John Recure. This is Wisconsin's Afternoon News. It is Wednesday, March 20th. Your top story, part of Northridge being demoed.
I'm Julia Fellow. Interest rates, where are they headed?
I'm Debbie Lozaga, and southbound on 43, backing up from Silver Spring down past Capitol Drive to about Keefe. Of course, we got that construction zone there. Northbound side slowing down right around the North Avenue curve up to Keefe. Westbound 94 slowing from 16th Street to Mitchell Boulevard. Eastbound's just a little bit heavy from about 68th Street to Mitchell Boulevard as well. And then, of course, we got your delays on 894 westbound through that construction zone, heading out of the Mitchell Interchange all the way to about 51st Street. And while you're out navigating the roads as quickly and safely as possible, if you do happen to see something we should know about, give us a call on the WTMJ Hall Volkswagen Traffic Tip Line. It's 414-238-9329. I'm Debbie Lozaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
Mainly clear tonight in Chile, a low of 24, mostly cloudy on Thursday. Expect some snow late in the evening. It could trickle into Friday. The morning commute could be a little dicey on Friday. Beware of that. High of 35 degrees for your Thursday. It's currently 35 in Milwaukee. At 3:02 from the WTMJ Breaking Newsroom, demolition begins at the former Boston store site at Northridge Mall. Milwaukee Mayor Cavalier Johnson on future plans for the site.
There's no grand plan just yet. But what I do know is that that mall should come down. So it's our intention to take that down and create a new space for a new opportunity to happen. I don't know what that is just yet, but certainly it'll be better than what is presently happening at that site right now.
City of Milwaukee took full possession of the site from U.S. Bank Spruce in January.
Milwaukee police need your help finding a hit-and-run driver. It took place yesterday near 13th and Atkinson. A 61-year-old pedestrian was rushed to the hospital, we're told, with life-threatening injuries. This crash took place just before 2 o'clock yesterday. The vehicle has a description, a blue four-door 2006 to 2007 Honda Accord with a black front bumper and extensive damage to the windshield. Also look for damage to the hood and a missing driver's headlamp. More details and photos are available right now for you to see at WTMJ.com.
Facing a $3.6 million budget shortfall due to accounting errors, the Glendale River Hills School District plans to discuss the ongoing issues with the community tonight. TMJ4's Sydney Orr.
On Tuesday, we know the school board talked about the potential for staff cuts for the next school year in order to make up for the shortfall. Some parents say they feel there has been a lack of transparency so far. The business manager and superintendent have submitted their resignation, and the district hired a financial firm to help discuss options for funding.
As a mother with a special ed kid, it's like, do I need to find another school district for her? Do we need to sell our house and move?
When we thought it through, we weren't going anywhere. We like the teachers too much. We like the people too much. A little disappointed.
The meeting will be held this evening at Glen Hills Middle School.
Embezzlement funds spent at the casino. Former Department of Public Works employees Kyle Kep and Kelly Whitmore Bailing reportedly embezzled hundreds of thousands of dollars from the city by underreporting sales of the DPW equipment. We're talking about large equipment and trucks. Urban Milwaukee's Jeremy Janine says the federal plea agreement shows that they sold a bulk of the equipment to someone named RG with the initials at the Central Repair Garage on Canal Street.
The report doesn't suggest that individual is going to face criminal charges, but it does, and I'm doing the air quotes right now, note he made a significant profit because he was getting stuff for under market value and reselling it.
If convicted, Hep and Whitmore Bailing face up to 15 years in prison.
Well, the Federal Reserve today keeping interest rates right where they are. ABC's Andy Field.
Fed Chair Jerome Powell saying the economy is still healthy and unemployment remains low.
But inflation is still too high. Ongoing progress in bringing it down is not assured, and the path forward is uncertain.
Which is why the Fed is keeping interest rates at 5.5% or lower, right where they've been since last summer. Board members saying they could start lowering rates as inflation moves closer to 2% a year. Andy Field, ABC News, Washington.
It's unclear if the Fed will start lowering interest rates at any point this year.
Coming up, the next generation of Little Rascals.
Siding Unlimited, WTMJ News Time is 3:06.
This report is sponsored by Diamonds Direct. Your love, their passion. Former pro football offensive tackle Mitch Schwartz knows for a guy, buying jewelry is a daunting task at most stores, but not if you go to Diamonds Direct.
It's very simple and very easy process for a guy to go in there and not be overwhelmed.
Mitch found Diamonds Direct and has been back many times buying jewelry for his wife, Brooke, and he's never felt any pressure.
They're going to educate you about what you're looking for, what the diamonds are, how the process works.
At Diamonds Direct, we respect both you and your budget.
I think everyone's kind of searching for value you don't want to be taken advantage of, and Diamonds Direct is leading in that regard. You're going to feel really comfortable there. You're going to have a good time. You're going to find something that looks amazing and that you're going to get the best value for it.
So if you're worried about getting sweaty palms when you walk into a jewelry store, relax. Take Mitch's advice and enjoy the experience at Diamonds Direct.
We have definitely recommended Diamonds Direct to friends, to other teammates. Everyone else who has been through there has had as awesome an experience as we have.
Diamonds Direct, your love, our passion. Get directions, showroom hours, and more at DiamondsDirect.com.
Another MVP has joined the roster at Orthopedic Associates of Wisconsin.
Dr. Michael Nolte.
ExpertScape recently named him part of the top 1% of spine expertise in the world. Dr. Nolte has published over 50 peer-reviewed articles in leading scientific journals and authored more than 100 national presentations. They added this MVP specialist for orthopedic, neurosurgical, and spine care because at Orthopedic Associates of Wisconsin, there is a difference.
Increase in taxes while families are paying more for everything from gas to groceries is wrong. Milwaukee voters should oppose increase in property taxes by nearly 30% in order to provide increased funding yet again to Milwaukee public schools. They've already wasted nearly $1 billion in new taxpayer funding, and now they want more? They don't even have a plan on how they'll spend it. Enough is enough. Milwaukee voters should just say no.
Paid for by Enough is Enough. Vote no.
Sidek Unlimited, WTMJ News. Time is 3:08.
Some young bank robbers busted. Here's CBS Stacey Lynn.
They're being called the Little Rascals. Three boys who are 11, 12, and 16 years old allegedly walked into a Wells Fargo bank in Houston and robbed the joint.
75 cents is a lot of money.
Yeah, that's almost $1 million.
Yeah.
The FBI says they threatened the teller, who handed over a bundle of cash. Then the boys took off on foot. But officials posted pictures of the bandits on social media, and they were caught.
See? That's just what I've been telling you, kids.
The Little Rascals were taken into custody and are now facing charges. Stacey Lynn, CBS News.
Time for a WTMJ sports update from the Gruber Law Offices. One call, that's all sports desk. It's a matchup of the two best teams in the Eastern Conference tonight as the Bucks take on the Celtics in Boston. Coverage gets underway at 6 o'clock on WTMJ. Brewers have won five straight Cactus League games. No game today, however. They'll next take the field in Arizona Thursday night. Opening day, 1 week from tomorrow in New York against the Mets.
Woohoo! Sighting Unlimited WTMJ News Time, 3:09.
Tax tips are brought to you by the Neal Group. For less stress with the IRS, visit nealgroup.net. That's N-E-A-L group.net for a free consultation.
Hi, this is John Neal, CPA and founder of the Neal Group, with a tip from Tucker the Tax Dog. Tax tip number 3. Do you know who you may be able to claim as a dependent? It is not only your children, plus they don't have to live with you the entire year. Qualifying relatives include parents, foster children, adopted children, brothers, sisters, and other relatives. As a general rule, you must provide over half of their support to be able to claim someone as a dependent. In a divorce situation, the non-custodial parent needs to have Form 8332 signed by the other parent in order to claim that child. This is regardless of what the divorce agreement says. Also, watch out if you have children in college. They may file a tax return claiming themselves. Many times it gives the child no benefit and causes your return to be rejected by the IRS. Good communication is essential in these cases to prevent problems. For more information on this tip and other tax tips, go to nealgroup.net or stop in and see us. You can give Tucker a belly rub and a milk bone.
Wisconsin's Afternoon News is on the air, broadcasting live from the Annex Wealth Management Studios at The Avenue in beautiful downtown Milwaukee. Here are your hosts, Greg Matzik and Julia Fellow.
There we go.
Well, I'm back.
Yes, you are. John McCure on vacation this week, getting some much-deserved rest and relaxation, pulling double duty, Greg Matzik. working Wisconsin's Midday News and now Wisconsin's Afternoon News. So happy you're with us.
Glad to be here again. A lot going on here. Boy, spring is starting to take effect here. Things are happening in the month of March. This is why I don't like February, because you're waiting for things to happen. Now things are happening. Basketball picking up. Opening day around the corner. Top Chef is tonight.
Yes.
We're in it.
And
this is the three. At 3 on Wisconsin's Afternoon News.
Well, never mind the forecast, but spring has officially sprung.
Yes, perfect lead-in. The first official day of spring was yesterday, and if you text WATCH to 855-616-1620, you can see a great sign of it. We're showing you a photo of the first egg laid by the Peregrine Falcons at the We Energies in Milwaukee. Such a beautiful color, isn't it?
Falcon egg? Yeah, this thing, it's like a swirl. It looks like Mars. It's like a swirling mass of red and orange in its egg shape. It's hard to tell exactly how big it is, but it's a falcon egg, so I'm guessing it's bigger than your standard
hefty
robin egg, right?
Yeah, and dark beautiful orange spots. All right, number two.
A woman in a coma for 5 years wakes up. This is amazing.
It's amazing. ABC News just shared the bigger story behind this. It's the mother's love. The woman was in Grand Rapids, Michigan, a 35-year-old mother of three, Jennifer Fellowin. She was in a bad car accident, struck a pole while driving, was in a coma for 5 years. Her mother never gave up hope. And take a listen. 5 years later, she was trying to tell her daughter a joke, and she woke up with this laughter. Take a listen.
That's what he told me.
There you go. And if you haven't used your muscles, Greg, including your vocal cords, in 5 years, you have to relearn everything. She's now learning to talk, and here she is in speech therapy.
The harder way is no.
Oh.
And oh, still pretty good. And the easier way is on. Very good. Try new.
Oh.
Keep going.
Isn't that incredible?
Unbelievable. Oh. So 5 years in a coma, having, you know, no earthly idea what's been happening around her for the last 5 years, and then trying to retrain her everyday habits. That's
everything.
Just incredible.
All right, what's next?
Well, how much money do you need to retire in the state of Wisconsin?
Our partners at Milwaukee Business Journal figured it out for us. So the national average, I think, is pretty high. I don't know. $1.8 million, according to Charles Schwab. In Wisconsin, to successfully be retired for at least 18 years and not have to worry, it's $1 million. The least expensive cities to retire include Wausau, Stevens Point, Kaukauna, and Manitowoc.
It is interesting. You know, the tax laws, you know, in varying states differ. So you might find that certain states are just, you know, easier to retire in than the state of Wisconsin. There are some tax benefits to living in Wisconsin in retirement. But the other thing we're finding, Julie, is that more and more people who are retired are finding ways to stay active and work because they're living longer. So you say 18 years, mm-hmm. That might assume a retirement age of 63 and then living until
80 something,
but people are living longer than ever before. They need more money than ever before.
Yes. All right. Coming up, the Environmental Protection Agency announced its final pollution standards for passenger cars. Hear that coming up.
What's up, Milwaukee? I'm here, Tanasa Antetokounmpo, my first live ever analysis with some guy. I don't know if you see his name.
Antetokounmpo throws it down, and a foul! Giannis on the alley-oop!
You can get your tickets at taliveshow.com. Can't wait for you guys to see Friday night with Giannis, all ages. You know what? Just be there.
The analysis live at Potawatomi Casino Hotel on March 22nd. Presented by Curbless Ready to Drink Cocktails. Get your tickets now at taliveshow.com.
Griffin Ford in Waukesha. It's the best thing going. WTMJ's John Mercier here. I know. I've bought numerous vehicles at Griffin Ford in Waukesha. Easy. It's off the interstate. Great selection. Even better service. And it's just easy when you're in Griffin Ford in Waukesha. Right now, check out the Bronco family at Griffin Ford. Over 200 new vehicles in stock. Ready to preview. They'll make best use of your time and the best bang for your buck. And it's truck month. I love this. Choose from over 50 new Ford F-150s and 250s. They stock more. That's why we help more people buy F-Series trucks than anyone around. And check out popular and affordable SUVs like the Ford Escape and the Bronco Sport. Griffin Ford service pickup and delivery for all customers. That's right. They'll pick you up You schedule an appointment, they'll bring you back home or work. It is a piece of cake. And the service department is the best service department in the area. It's Griffin Ford Waukesha, Carfax top-rated dealer award winner. Stop into Griffin Ford today. Shop where I do at Griffin Ford.
Get 0% interest for up to 3 years at Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. I'm Gina Della from Pella. Pella's free in-home consultations make replacing or redesigning your windows and doors easy. We go beyond just measuring and handing you a quote by listening and educating you on all of your product options. And with DesignWorks, you can see what your home will look like before you buy. Order by March 31st to get 0% interest for up to 3 years. Set your free consultation at PellaWI.com.
Certain restrictions apply.
Traffic is sponsored by COWAL Investment Group, the retirement specialists. Retire well with COWAL.
When was the last time you had a second opinion on your retirement plan? If you have $750,000 or more, schedule your retirement review with one of our fiduciary advisors at thecowalway.com.
Traffic and weather. Let's get a look outside on the roads with Debbie Lazaga.
All right. Well, we've got southbound 43 backing up just a little bit from just before Hampton Avenue all the way down past Capitol Drive to about Keefe. The northbound side slowing down right around the North Avenue curve in English, and it's all the way up to Keefe there. Westbound on 94 backing up from 16th Street through the stadium interchange to about Moreland or... just past the stadium interchange. Eastbound side's a little bit backed up as well, right in the stadium interchange proper. And along 894 westbound, say it with me, slowing down from the Mitchell all the way to Forest Home. I'm Debbie Lazaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
Sunny day, but a chilly day. Temperatures topping out about 36 degrees. That's all right. Overnight low of 25. Mid-30s your high tomorrow. Snow arriving late Thursday, and it could affect your morning commute on Friday. The timing's still a little bit unclear. We'll get an update from NIS coming up a little later in the program, about 5:35. But temperatures expected to top out in the mid to upper 30s for the next 4 or 5 days. It is 35 degrees in Milwaukee at 3:18.
Less than a minute to talk about this, Greg, but the Environmental Protection Agency finally announced a curtailed final pollution standard for passenger cars. So we thought that it was going to be forecasted for them to have all electric vehicles that are mostly produced for the everyday person like you and I to be about 40% of their light duty vehicle sales to be electric vehicles. Actually, it was forecasted to be 70%. Now it's 40%. There's a lot of hesitation with it. I don't know if you went to the auto show that just recently came to Milwaukee. Did you?
I did, and I enjoy it. What I've noticed, though, is a pivot in advertising, right? I mean, 2 years ago in the Super Bowl, it was all about the next line of EV vehicles for the likes of GM and beyond. And while those are still being made, I'm finding that they're shifting more toward hybrid vehicles, mm-hmm. a lot of these manufacturers, which I think is interesting. While you might reduce emissions with a hybrid or an EV, the mining for lithium isn't exactly environmentally safe. So there still is kind of this pull on whether EVs are going to take over. We're not there yet, that's for sure.
So it's called range anxiety. That's what they call it. And there's also a worry over the lack of charging stations. In Wisconsin, we rank 43rd in the country, according to a watchdog group. So we have a lot to work on. Governor Evers just was given about $80 million in federal funds under President Biden's bipartisan infrastructure law to begin construction on that network. So that's good news. But for a lot of people, they were wondering, especially people in the auto industry, they were trying to get the Biden administration to not have it go up to nearly 70% of electric vehicle sales. Now it will be forecasted by 2027, 2030. Or 2030, it's going to be about 40% of all vehicle sales will be EVs. There you go. The time right now is 3:20 on WTMJ.
Hey, WTMJ's John Mercure here to talk to you a little bit about Town Bank. I've been with Town Bank for a very long time. Used to be with a different bank, a big bank here in Wisconsin. I didn't get the customer service that I needed, didn't have the banking solutions that my family counted on. Town Bank takes care of us big time. Do you check your bank account sometimes and feel like you aren't saving at all? This is a great example. At Town Bank, they view banking differently, and they actually want to see your savings grow. So they're saying maybe don't do the savings account. They have amazing CD rates. You can now earn even more so you can sit back and relax and just watch it grow. Stop banking the same way, expecting different results, and start earning more. It's Town Bank. Best customer service, philanthropic in your neighborhoods. Online presence is robust. It's real. I pay my bills online. I use the app all the time. Rarely go into the actual bank. And at Town Bank, they've got me covered. They have the best systems, and they just make it easy. For more information, go to townbank.us. It's that easy. Best bank. Wisconsin's bank. Town Bank. Bank differently with Town Bank. Member FDIC.
Since 1946, Ansay & Associates has provided insurance to help secure businesses and families throughout Wisconsin. With custom coverage and superior customer service, Ansay & Associates can provide all of your insurance needs. Visit ansay.com today and get a free consultation with one of our strategists. Or come see us in person at any of our local offices. Ansay & Associates, securing and protecting your American dream.
Nelnet Incorporated, the nation's largest, most respected student loan servicer, has document imaging technology from James Imaging Systems. Facilities coordinator, Sunday Heideman.
James Imaging has been a local provider for us for many years. They are reliable, they're responsible, and they take care of all of our printer needs.
Just what you'd expect from a 100% Wisconsin-owned and managed business technology company.
I think we get a great value with James Imaging, with their service and the contracts that we have with them, that our cost stays low and we get the most for our money.
Sunday, what's the benefit for you with James Imaging Systems?
It makes my job more enjoyable that I can count on these people to do what they're trained to do, and I have no worries because I know I'm going to be taken care of.
James Imaging Systems. Call 262-781-7700. James Imaging Systems, your local business technology partner.
Whether you're seeking endless sunshine, ancient landmarks, or scenic views, Fox World Travel can take you there. We are proud to partner with outstanding cruise companies, including Holland America, Princess Cruises, Celebrity, and Royal Caribbean, to bring you unbeatable rates for your next cruise. Unleash your inner adventurer and book your dream cruise by visiting foxworldtravel.com or calling us at 866-GO-FOX-GO. Enjoy the freedom of unpacking once and set sail for adventure.
U.S. Secretary of State Anthony Blinken to visit Saudi Arabia, Egypt, and Israel to work on a ceasefire in Gaza. ABC News correspondent Jordana Miller joins us on the phone from Jerusalem. Jordana, good afternoon.
Good afternoon. Secretary of State Anthony Blinken will come here to this region with so much on his plate. First of all, the ceasefire talks and hostage release talks, which started just a couple days ago in Qatar. He's going to do anything he can to advance those talks and, you know, close the gaps between the sides. There's still a lot of outstanding issues, including how many Palestinian prisoners Israel will release for each freed hostage. And in this phase one, it'll be about 40 Israeli hostages in exchange for that six-week ceasefire. Other issues, including where the Israeli army will deploy, which of displaced Gazans, who can actually return to the north, right? Israel doesn't want men of fighting age in the north because they fear they'll join militant groups or the insurgency there. So a lot of issues. And, of course, the main dispute between Israel and the United States, the Rafah operation that Israel wants to carry out, a military assault on that border city where more than a million Gazans are sheltering. Well, the president's been clear that he opposes a massive ground operation. He's summoned Israeli leaders to Washington. They will be coming next week to discuss what the president calls other options, other ways to target Hamas in that area without involving a massive ground operation, even though Israel's prime minister has said he has a plan to evacuate civilians from the area. That does not appear to have convinced the president that it will be safe enough for all those civilians.
Jordana, there's no clear end in sight here to the war. Relations between the two countries have never been great. They have only soured, really, since it's begun. does that matter in the grand scheme of things?
Well, I mean, the United States' support for this war is critical, not just in words, not just diplomatically, but remember, the United States is supplying Israel with all kinds of additional military weapons, vehicles. I mean, you know, Israel would have a much harder time fighting this war if the United States decided to stop arms sales to Israel. And, you know, when you take into consideration that we don't know exactly what's going to happen on the northern border, that is, if war will possibly break out between Israel and Hezbollah, that's a second front. And that American military help would be, you know, even more essential if Israel finds itself fighting on two fronts. So, you know, the Israeli-American relationship really is deep and it is enduring. And I do expect that Israel and the United States will come to some kind of compromise over the Rafah operation. You know, it's not going to be something that will break this relationship.
ABC's Jordana Miller, great insight as always. Jordana, we'll check in again soon.
Thanks. Talk soon.
3:27 on WTMJ. Time for an Annex Wealth Management market update. A late rally pushed all the indices well into the green today. The Dow finishing up over 400 points at 39,512. NASDAQ finishes up 202 points at 16,369. And the S&P 500 up about 46 points today, closing at 5224 and change. For sound financial advice from a fee-only fiduciary, it's Annex Wealth Management. Click on annexwealth.com and the Get Started button today.
Like it or not, you are a media-consuming machine, chased all day by headlines, texts, emails, on the TV, the computer, the phone, even your smartwatch. News about market volatility and uncertainty could lead to anxiety and planning paralysis. No surprise, Americans report increased stress about their investment and retirement plans. This isn't a time to be frozen in place. Take action. Put Annex Wealth Management on your side. Build a plan that will help cut through the noise. We'll provide comprehensive investment and retirement guidance that includes tax and estate planning. Let Annex do a deep dive on your portfolio, offer unbiased advice with Wealthmetric, and work to create a solid plan for you and your family. Turn down the media roar. Dial up the planning. Head to annexwealth.com and click the Get Started button. It takes only a couple of minutes. Set your own appointment. In person or online, it's time to take action and know the difference with a fee-only fiduciary. That's Annex Wealth Management, annexwealth.com.
Hey, Gene Miller here. The heart of winter is the best time to call my friends at Hometown Windows and Doors. Save heating and cooling dollars down the road with energy-efficient replacement windows and doors from brands like Pella, Anderson, Marvin, and more. Hometown is your local source for wood, vinyl, or fiberglass, plus all of their products are installed by employee carpenters. Stop into their newly remodeled showroom in New Berlin and see the Hometown difference. That's Hometown with an E for your every window and door need. HometownWindows.com.
We've gotten used to recycling our old junk whenever possible. But what about the junk in our lives? Old regrets, past mistakes, broken relationships. Dr. Michael Ziegler tells how Jesus will salvage, forgive, restore, and repurpose everything we give him. Hear Dr. Ziegler's message, Repurposed Junk and Joy, this week on the Lutheran Hour.
The Lutheran Hour, Sunday mornings at 6:30 on WTMJ.
Traffic is sponsored by St. Vincent de Paul Thrift Stores.
St. Vincent de Paul Thrift Stores, Highway 100 and Layton Avenue, 23rd and Lincoln. Great stores, great cause, and unbelievable bargains. You're going to love it. St. Vincent de Paul Thrift Stores.
Wisconsin's Afternoon News on Wisconsin's radio station, News Radio WTMJ.
It's 3:30. I'm Greg Matzik. Your top story, FedEx shooting spree, suspect charged.
I'm Julia Fellow, girl power at City Hall.
I'm Debbie Lozaga. Got some backups on 41 southbound starting at Silver Spring down past Capitol Drive. Southbound 43 has its own delays right at that point, too. Silver Spring all the way down past Keith. But the northbound side backing up from Fond du Lac Avenue all the way up past Keith as well. Westbound 94, watch for delays starting before the Marquette all the way through to about Hawley Road, with the eastbound side slowing from 92nd Street on and off the brakes through the stadium interchange. I'm Debbie Lozaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
Mainly clear tonight with a low of 24, cloudy on Thursday, snow late in the evening, maybe into Friday morning as well, with a high of 35. It's 35 degrees in Milwaukee at 3:31. From the WTMJ Breaking Newsroom, a former FedEx employee charged after firing dozens of shots inside a Menomonee Falls facility. Isaiah Dorsey of Waukesha faces charges of felony armed burglary with a dangerous weapon, criminal damage to property, and resisting arrest. Officers say Dorsey entered the facility near Pilgrim Road and County Line Road in Menomonee Falls with a semi-automatic handgun and fired two dozen shots inside the building. Thankfully, no one was injured. His next hearing is set for Monday.
The jury deliberating the fate of former Milwaukee Election Commission Deputy Director Kimberly Zapata is underway. She is accused of illegally requesting three absentee military ballots and having them sent to Menomonee Falls State Representative Janelle Branchin.
In her press release, Janelle Branchin says, "I believe someone was trying to point out how easy it is to get military ballots in Wisconsin. A fictitious name and birth date is all that is required."
The defense indicating military voters don't need to register to vote or show a photo ID to request a ballot. Milwaukee Election Commissioner Claire Woodall-Vogg testified Tuesday. She believes Zapata was attempting to
highlight to the conspirators what a real potential security concern would be surrounding the MyVote website.
Jessica Gatso, WTMJ News.
Well, the mayor of Waupun says he's hopeful a new graduating class of cadets will help staffing at Waupun Correctional, the state prison under investigation after four inmate deaths since last year. Waupun Mayor Ron Bishop tells WTMJ he's confident in some of the changes that have been made.
If you go to the academy and you graduate and you start at Waupun Correctional on Monday, you're making $44 an hour. So the last graduating class had like 270 cadets. I think that's going to help with the staffing.
Waupun Correctional and Fox Lake Correctional is where the cadets will likely begin.
A group of Milwaukee voters are voicing their concerns with the proposed Milwaukee Public Schools referendum.
Vote no!
Robin Kitzrow was a former MPS principal and was with the group Milwaukeeans for Affordable Housing protesting the $252 million referendum outside City Hall today. She tells WTMJ instead of a referendum, the district should focus on policies aimed at competing with voucher schools.
We have so many schools that are under capacity, and adding that to more poverty, I think we will find that we have a lot of problems in terms of academic achievement with the students.
Adam Roberts, WTMJ News.
Superintendent Dr. Keith Polsley previously said in Wisconsin's Afternoon News that the districts plan to use the referendum money to maintain new and existing services. Another Wisconsin college in danger of closing their doors.
Northland College in Ashland says they need to raise $12 million by April 3rd, or the school will begin the process of closing after this academic year. A review by the Board of Trustees and college leadership confirmed the school does not have sufficient resources to continue programs and operations beyond this year. Northland is the latest in a series of Wisconsin campuses in danger of shutting down. Last week, UW-Milwaukee announced that it will close its branch campus in Waukesha in the spring of 2025. Adam Roberts, WTMJ News.
The 14th annual Girls' Day at City Hall inspires the youth of Milwaukee.
Alderwoman Andrea Pratt was a panelist at the event. She tells WTMJ,
"Just to see all these young ladies have access to City Hall and all these dynamic women who can help them learn how to blaze their own trails is overwhelming. It's exciting."
Middle schooler Dahlia says with all these women, she's
very happy to see them doing what they do, and it means a lot to me. It's nice to see that our city has a day just for girls to see what they can do if they want to.
Julian Johnson, WTMJ News.
A bittersweet ending for a sweet spot at Bayshore Mall. Kilwin's Candy Shop is closing its doors on Monday. The owners announced their retirement and the store is closing on Facebook. They opened Kilwin's in 2014 after working in the medical field. A retirement sale at the store runs through Monday.
Time for a WTMJ sports update from the Gruber Law Office's One Call, That's All sports desk. Bucks and Celtics tonight from Boston. Coverage gets underway at 6 o'clock on WTMJ in a matchup of the two best teams in the Eastern Conference, according to the records. Brewers have won five straight in the Cactus League. They'll take the field tomorrow night in Arizona against the Giants. And opening day is 1 week from tomorrow in New York against the Mets.
Sighting Unlimited, WTMJ News Time, 3:36.
This report is sponsored by Diamonds Direct. Your love, their passion.
Okay, I'm ready to record my jewelry store's new radio spot. We got a great script that really goes after Diamonds Direct and how they're nothing special. And how we can match their price. Great stuff. Yeah.
Great, great. And we have this new technology that bleeps out any false claims, so it saves us time with editing. So you can start anytime.
Okay, here it goes. When you visit our jewelry store, we'll absolutely guarantee direct... Our diamonds come straight from the mine. We have cutters and... Hey, what the...
The hard truth is that other jewelry stores simply can't do what Diamonds Direct can. Diamonds Direct has special relationships with De Beers, international connections, and virtually unlimited buying power. The result is true direct importer pricing, exceptional quality, and up to 30 times the diamond selection you find at other stores.
I can't believe this thing won't let me say...
Diamonds Direct. Your love... Our passion. Get more truth at DiamondsDirect.com.
Wisconsin's Afternoon News on WTMJ.
Kind of perfect having the cha-ching for bad reason here. There are two now former City of Milwaukee Public Works Department workers who are accused of selling vehicles and equipment. They've now pled guilty to this. Selling it to friends for cheap, we're talking about big things like trucks and John Deere equipment, and then using the money they pocketed to gamble at the casino.
Yeah, so Jeremy Janine of Urban Milwaukee broke the story. He spoke about exactly what you just referenced.
And then to add insult to injury, they then would go buy money orders for about 10% of what they sold it for. So they kind of robbed the taxpayers twice. They both now signed federal felony plea agreements. The last point that they had to stipulate to was that they were excessively visiting Pottawatomie Hotel and Casino, which is just down the street from where they were doing
so. Yeah, so foolish on so many fronts here. They face up to 15 years in prison, more than $350,000 in restitution and fines. Oh, by the way, good luck getting a job again. So this is all sorts of bad.
So it's Kyle Hepp, Fleet Acquisitions Manager, and Kelly Whitmore Bailing that have both pled guilty. So the exact amount that they are accused of pocketing is $136,000 in city equipment that they sold off. Here's an example. We're talking about a John Deere backhoe and even a Freightliner truck belonging to the City of Milwaukee, paid for by your tax dollars. That backhoe, for example, was worth $35,000 according to the criminal complaint, and it was sold for $2,000. To somebody else, and then that friend sold it again. So I'm not really sure exactly how this took place for so long. I'm sure that will come out once all of this is said and done. But there is restitution of nearly $400,000, which is the fair market value of what they have pled guilty to stealing. Now, they both face up to 15 years in prison, but it looks like they may have done a plea agreement at this time.
Well, it's a skimming operation, right? They sell for less than its value. They find ways to get money off the top. They go gamble away that money at Pottawatomie. Who knows how well they did with that money, and if more will be on the back for them to repay. But yes, nearly $400,000 worth of stuff was sold off, and they pocketed about a quarter of those dollars, a little more than a quarter. So this goes back to roughly. Well, 2014, when Whitmore Bailing was hired, Hepp was hired in 2021 as the fleet acquisition manager. So at some point, they became co-workers and likely just in cahoots working on this operation. They both resigned in lieu of discharge in December of 22. This is according to the city's Department of Employment Relations. So out of a job at this point, and presumably for who knows how long, especially if they end up in prison. So it's just it's a reminder of exactly what not to do mm-hmm. when you're in a position of power. But cheating the taxpayers twice will never go over well with anybody.
No.
Your employer. I mean, just you name it. They did everything absolutely wrong in hatching this scheme.
From DPW worker to inmate number XYZ, who knows what it's going to be? That's terrible. I just think it's greed. Once you get to, almost $500,000, you think you're not going to be caught? I mean, apparently they're allowed to do that. The title that they had was Fleet Acquisitions Manager. So they could do that. They could buy and sell. You're supposed to do it at an arm's length, not someone that you know, which allegedly is what happened in the criminal complaint. But yes, once again, these two former Milwaukee Public Works Department workers pocketed money and gambled it at the casino.
If you're smart enough to hatch the plan to try and make this work, you think you'd be smart enough to avoid Pottawatomie?
Oh, totally. You're right, on the radar.
I don't know. It seems like a well-devised scheme until you get a little too greedy and take your earnings /earnings to Pottawatomie. Wow. Or they've got surveillance of them doing that.
Oh, every move. Every move that they had of that cash. Stolen cash, mind you.
Foolish on many fronts. No doubt about that.
All right, what's coming up?
3:42 on WTMJ. Lots to get to this hour, including a conversation with Robin Voss. He is going to join us here about 4:30 this afternoon. Coming up next, you want to play the lottery and win money the legal way? Well, you can do it. The jackpots are growing. There's a couple of them we're paying attention to. Over $1 billion available if you are lucky enough. 3:41 on WTMJ.
If you missed this,
Rick Schlesinger is with us. What are you highlighting this year?
We're taking some of the best food offerings from the very popular market hall and bringing them to the lowest level, and that's just the starters.
Or this.
Joining us is Dr. Ellen Hayes. You had a lengthy statement. We are deeply troubled by the intrusion of politics into the relationship between doctor and patient. Can you talk more about that?
A lot of these are very sensitive areas, and complicated decision-making is needed.
Check out Wisconsin's Afternoon News, the podcast.
It's John Merck here for the Freightert and the Medical College of Wisconsin Health Network. Precision medicine has become a growing trend in treating various conditions. It's often used for serious diseases like cancer. What is precision medicine and how's it used? To find out and to learn more about precision medicine, listen to my discussion with Dr. Huizi Chen, who specializes in lung cancer and rare cancers with the Freightert and the Medical College of Wisconsin Health Network. Hear that conversation and any of our past everyday health chats by visiting the features drop-down menu at WTMJ.com.
Hey, it's WTMJ's Steve Scafidi for the Bath Authority. The Bath Authority provides the highest quality bathroom remodeling products along with a world-class customer experience. Walk-in tubs, replacement showers, tub-to-shower conversions, and so much more. Every unit is custom-built. Elevate your bathroom to a new level of luxury, style, and safety. Schedule your free in-home estimate today and get $1,000 off a new shower or bath, plus 36 months of interest-free financing. TheBathAuthority.com. A better bath awaits.
At the Bath Authority.
Unless the grain of wheat falls to the ground and dies, it remains just a grain of wheat. But if it dies, it produces much fruit. Hello, this is Archbishop Lestecki. Jesus is the very bread of life. Like the grain of wheat, he suffers and dies so that we might live with him forever. The Eucharist is real food, multiplying his love in all of us. It's Lent. Join us at Mass.
I'm going to say it again. Our mission is to protect and uphold our reputation. And what that means is wherever we go, we make it better for those in need of our services and the great people we have working with us. Our reputation matters. Over the years, we've cut our losses with a handful of people that just didn't live our values as much as we'd like. And a lot of them, if not all of them, still work in the industry today. I say this because I want you to know when you work with Semper Fi, character counts. It's why you can count on the industry's hands-down best lifetime workmanship warranty that now includes free annual inspections. And it's why we always have one project manager per job, which is absolutely not the industry standard. When you're paying for a brand new roof to go on what's likely the biggest investment you have, you want it done right, and you want to be able to count on the people doing it. This is Brad Youngluth with Semper Fi Roofing and Exteriors, your local, veteran-owned and operated exterior remodeling company.
We keep you safe, warm, and dry, Semper Fi.
Traffic is sponsored by Richlawn's Tire and Service Center.
Richlawn's Tire and Service Centers, 5 locations and all easy to find. Visit richlawns.com when you're due for service.
Traffic and weather at 3:45 on WTMJ. Debbie Lozaga has got a look at the roads. Hi, Deb.
All right. Well, the usual suspects are chiming in here. We've got 43 southbound slowing from Silver Spring all the way down past Keith. Northbound's backing up from before Fond du Lac Avenue all the way up to about Capitol Drive. Westbound 94, slow out of the Marquette all the way to Mitchell Boulevard. Southbound 41's even getting into the act. A couple taps of the brakes from Silver Spring down past Hampton Avenue and again past Capitol. And of course, we've got our delays along the construction zone on 894 westbound, out of the Mitchell Interchange, pretty much all the way past 68th Street. I'm Debbie Lozaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
Kind of a chilly day, sunny conditions, but not exactly warm. We'll top out about 37 today. Overnight low of 24 under clear skies. Cloudy tomorrow, high of 37. Snow very late and into Friday morning. A potential to impact your commute, so be on the lookout for the timing. Brian Desnansky will join us coming up about 5:35 with an update. But we're in the 30s for the next 4 or 5 days here in Wisconsin. It's 34 degrees in Milwaukee at 3:46.
Lottery jackpots, they continue to grow with Mega Millions nearing $1 billion. We have Derek Dennis with ABC News joining us on the phone. That's head spinning, Derek.
Oh, massive. A massive jackpot up for grabs in the Mega Millions this Friday. That's the next drawing that'll happen. $977 million, almost $1 billion is what the jackpot will yield for a lucky winner or winners. No one won last night's drawing, and so the jackpot just keeps growing and growing to the staggering amount. The cash value, just a fraction of it, though, about $460 million is what people will take if they choose the cash lump sum option. Still, it's a lot of money, and people are lining up to buy tickets all over using either their birthdays or other important dates, any number combination, including the computer-generated numbers, to try and win.
So, Derek, if you combine that Mega Millions with Powerball, which is nearly $700 million, right. I don't know if the two major lotteries have had a collective over $1.3 billion available. Like, this seems like the highest totals I can ever remember combined.
Well, there have been bigger jackpots for sure. We've had a jackpot of over $1 billion previously. So this is certainly up there, one of the largest jackpots that's up for grab, but not the largest. And would it be something to win Powerball and Mega Millions? Wow, you have to be really lucky to win both. But the Powerball drawing is tonight. That $687 million jackpot is up for grabs. Mega Millions is on Friday.
You're a little skeptical, aren't you, Greg?
Do you play the same numbers for both?
I would.
I mean, the odds, I think, would be similar. Might be a little bit different. So, Derek, I'm interested to know if you've got a correspondence pool, you know, like you and Sherry Preston and Alex Stone and Karen Travers and the Foreign Desk, like everybody just sort of gets together and you have a correspondence pool.
Funny you should say that. We sure do. All the names you mentioned, plus those who aren't on the air, we have all chipped in our, I think it's $2 we're all contributing. And then someone goes and buys tickets for the newsroom. And that's how people across the country are playing. They're getting into pools, office pools, neighborhood pools, building pools, whatever, to try and increase their odds. But the odds are still staggering. For Mega Millions, it's 1 in 302 million. That's the odds of winning. For Powerball, 1 in 292 million. So staggering odds. But as they say, you got to play the win.
Our newsroom at TMJ4 also had that too. Were you part of that?
You never wanted to be out of it, right, Derek?
No.
Right? The odds are astronomically against any one of us playing, but you never wanted to be out of the office pool because you didn't want to be the one looking at all the empty desk chairs spinning from those who won.
Okay, gentlemen.
Right.
I have a question. What would you do with the money if you won either one? Derek first.
Oh, gosh. Well, the first thing is I would be immediately retiring for sure. You would never see or hear from me again.
Exactly right.
And I think a lot of people would have that same feeling. Why work when you have this much money in the bank? There's no reason. You just become a perpetual vacationer. And doesn't that sound great?
Greg, would you be a minority owner somewhere?
Okay, so here's the thing. I've got two small children. They are 9 and 7 years old. My wife and I have talked about this. If it were to happen, no, I don't think she and I would work anymore. We might do stuff to keep ourselves busy. But I think the goal for us would be to try and make sure our kids live as normal a life as possible and not be too extravagant with what we were so lucky to win. So they're still going to school every day. They're still cleaning their room every day. They're still doing the things that we do together as a family.
It's like we have the money.
We might have an extra house somewhere and maybe a country club membership, but I'd like to think that we try and be as normal as possible.
Your kids don't want to hear that. They don't want to be normal.
Right.
I would still live here probably, but I would definitely have a few homes in maybe California and New York and Hawaii. There you go.
Can't go wrong.
One can wish. That's the best part about this, isn't it?
Well, Milwaukee's great in the summertime, so and winter too, I would say. But, you know, why not stick around Milwaukee? I've been to your station, by the way. Is it still on Capitol Drive?
Well, we used to be. We've now relocated more into downtown Milwaukee, brand new studios. We've got a tour set up for you, Derek, anytime you want to come.
Oh, it's state-of-the-art. You're going to love it.
Plenty of places to buy lottery tickets, for sure, all around Milwaukee and Wisconsin.
Well, there is no doubt about that.
Derek Dennis with the Plum Spot. So happy that you got to talk with us today about the lottery jackpots. I hope you have a great day.
Yes. All right.
Derek Dennis of ABC News joining us. So very interesting stuff here. Now, and maybe, just maybe, if you won the lottery, you wouldn't have to have stole the ruby slippers worn in The Wizard of Oz. Did you see that? So there's another man charged in connection with the 2005 theft of the ruby slippers worn in The Wizard of Oz.
They're so beautiful.
They're gorgeous. I mean, they really are different. My kids have finally watched The Wizard of Oz. They're still a little confused by some of the things and, quite frankly, a little bit frightened by some of the things in that movie. But this story goes back several years ago. These are the slippers once worn by Judy Garland in The Wizard of Oz, and they're displayed in the picture I'm looking at the FBI office in Brooklyn Center, Minnesota. So another man has been charged in connection with the theft of these slippers, and we're learning more and more. Jerry Hall Salterman, 76 years old, of Crystal, Minnesota, was charged with theft of a major piece of artwork and witness tampering. He did not enter a plea when he made his first appearance Friday in U.S. District Court in St. Paul. But these are priceless, right? I mean, I don't know what they'd sell for at auction, but they were worn by Judy Garland in the 1939 movie. These would fetch a pretty penny at auction. These would fetch millions at auction.
And it's been missing for a long time. The man who's accused was wheeled in with an oxygen tank. If you take a look at the left shoe, it says Judy Garland inside of the shoe. It's just so special. Did your daughters like the movie?
Sort of. It's not really their jam. They're a little more into the animated kind of stuff. If it's not Harry Potter, it needs to be animated. That's kind of where they stand.
I watched it in the 80s and I absolutely loved it. And you know what I told my dad? I said, I want to see it. When is Judy Garland in another movie? And you know what my dad said?
Yeah, well, time
she's
has passed.
Dead. That's what he said to me. Oh, man. I was like 3 years old, like, Judy Garland, what happened to her?
These are said to have a value at $3.5 million, according to federal prosecutors. But if these go on auction, who knows, right? I mean, that price could be driven up, maybe go for less. Garland, born in 1922. She lived in Michigan, about 200 miles or so. Or she lived, I'm sorry, in Minnesota. So this is kind of why the slippers were on display. Another Minnesota man is being charged in connection to the stolen slippers once worn by Judy Garland.
Naughty.
Hey, if you're looking for something to do on Friday, tickets are available here. See Giannis and his brother, Thanasis. No, not at Fiserv Forum. On stage at Pottawatomie Casino Hotel. See them like you've never seen them before. This is a once in a lifetime, who knows, event. But it's the first of its kind. It's Thanasis Live featuring Giannis and his brother, Thanasis. And it'll be at Pottawatomie Casino Hotel Friday. It's an all-ages show. Doors open at 6. Show begins at 7. If you're interested in checking this out, and tickets are going pretty fast, all you have to do is text the word POD. That's P-O-D. Text the word POD, as in podcast, to 855-616-1620. We'll send all the details right to your smartphone. You want to get in on this. I'm bummed I'm going to miss it, Julia. But it is available for you to witness. You and your family. Bring whoever you'd like. Come see Giannis and Thanasis. It's Thanasis Live at Pottawatomie Casino Hotel on Friday.
Awesome. Hey, I have some breaking news. I just got notified. You know, the jury that was deliberating the fate of former Milwaukee Election Commission Deputy Director Kimberly Zapata, she has been found guilty. This is just into our newsroom. She was accused of illegally requesting three absentee military ballots and having them sent to Menominee Falls State Representative Janelle Branchin. Looks like they deliberated for a few hours. There was closing arguments this morning. And so here we go. Former Milwaukee elections official Kimberly Zapata, accused of faking military absentee ballots, has been found guilty. We hope to have more details at the top of the hour.
3:56 on WTMJ. Business headlines coming up in a moment.
Papa Luigi's Pizza in Cudahy plans to expand its kitchen space by 1,100 feet to provide staff more room to serve customers and a high demand for pizza that can become as much as 400 pizzas on weekend nights. It will be the restaurant's third expansion since it opened 42 years ago. Milwaukee County's pursuit of more federal grants includes applying later this year for money to build a new international terminal at Milwaukee Mitchell International Airport. If the county can secure federal construction grants next year, it could mean more international flights into and out of Mitchell Airport as early as 2026 or 2027. Moore Construction Services purchases the former Schwabenhof property in Menominee Falls, which served its last fish fry in 2022. Moore Construction plans to use the 21.5 acres purchased for industrial development and potentially to reopen the restaurant. I'm Linda Spice with MilwaukeeBusinessJournal.com on News Radio WTMJ.
WTMJ, W277CV, and WKTI HD2 Milwaukee. From the Annex Wealth Management Studios, this is News Radio WTMJ, a Good Karma brand station.
Now, this report, sponsored by the Pfister Hotel. Make your reservations today. Visit thepfisterhotel.com.
For over 130 years, the Pfister Hotel in downtown Milwaukee has been delighting guests with impeccable service and luxurious accommodations. Celebrate your next special occasion with a stay at the Pfister. Enjoy fine dining at its acclaimed restaurants and pamper yourself with a service from the Well Spa and Salon. Experience the hotel's afternoon tea program or take in live music with the best views of the city from Blue, the 23rd floor cocktail lounge. There's always a reason to celebrate with the Pfister Hotel. Make your reservations today at thepfisterhotel.com.
Since 1955, Geist Garage Doors has been the trusted authority in Wisconsin. Hey, it's Greg Bancic. Don't let a busted garage door get you down. Give my friends at Geist a call. Doors and openers for every budget are available, and they'll even build custom designs to meet your exact needs. Check out geistdoors.com or call 262-784-4250. Or do what I did. Check out their amazing showroom in Brookfield featuring hundreds of doors, openers, and their custom design room. Wherever you are in southeast Wisconsin, don't think twice. Call Geist.
Don't think twice.
Hi, I'm Mike Ganzi from Ansi & Associates. We're passionate about continuing on our mission to help more Wisconsin businesses create more success. If you have any questions about our insurance products or just want a second opinion about your insurance or employee benefits, I invite you to check out ansi.com, or better yet, give us a call at Ansi & Associates. And let's have a conversation about your business and how we can help you secure, protect, and grow your version of the American dream.
Hey, WTMJ's John Merck here for one of my favorite places. The Fox and Hound Supper Club is the most unique, beautiful, and affordable dining destination in the area. Winners of the Top Choice Award for Fine Dining, Most Romantic Restaurant, and Best Sunday Brunch. When you buy one dinner, your second dinner is free, always, 7 nights a week. Steak, seafood, ribs, pasta, big fresh salad, even the steak and lobster. Any dinner on the menu, your second dinner is free. That includes prime rib on Wednesdays and Saturdays. Desserts are also always buy one, get one free, and they're delicious. Relax with a hand-muddled old-fashioned, 20 bourbons, 100 wines, and one of their 8 elegant dining rooms. The Fox and Hound sits in the Kettle Moraine Forest, a spectacular setting. Celebrate a birthday, anniversary, or a quiet dinner with your love, and your second dinner is free. Just off Highway 167, 2 miles east of Holy Hill, the drive is beautiful. Reserve at foxandhoundsrestaurant.com for your free dinner. Tonight, it's the Fox and Hounds.
For WTMJ contest rules, visit WTMJ.com/contests.
Griffin is your one-stop shop this March. For only $179.95, we offer an all-exclusive package to spruce up your ride. Get an oil change, tire rotation, air filter, wiper blades, multi-point inspection, battery check, and heat inspection. Griffin, your spring drive starts here.
You can't beat Bernhardt.
New Berlin and Fox Point.
Traffic sponsored by Cendix Food Market, your trusted local grocer since 1926.
Local savings start at Cendix. Sargento shredded cheese in 5 to 8 ounce packages are 2 for $6 all this week. Cendix, your trusted local grocer.
Your trusted and relevant source for news, sports, traffic, and weather. We are Wisconsin's radio station. News Radio 620, WTMJ, Milwaukee.
It's 4 o'clock. I'm Greg Matzik. This is Wisconsin's Afternoon News for Wednesday, March 20th. Your top story, protesting during the RNC.
I'm Julia Fellow. A verdict in the ballot fraud trial.
I'm Debbie Lozaga. Westbound on 894, backing up through the Mitchell Interchange all the way to about 68th Street. That's that construction slowdown. That left lane is blocked off with barrels because they're working on the median area. Westbound 94, slow from before the Marquette all the way to Holly Road. Eastbound slowing from before 84th Street through the stadium. And northbound 43, kind of heavy from before Fond du Lac Avenue all the way up to Keith, with the southbound side slowing down from Silver Spring all the way down past Keith as well. I'm Debbie Lozaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
Sunny, windy, chilly today. It'll be so tonight as well under clear skies. A low of 25 into the mid-30s tomorrow. Snow late on your Thursday. Could impact your commute on Friday morning. Friday's high also in the mid-30s. Going to kind of be in that rut for the next several days. It is 35 degrees in Milwaukee at 4:02. From the WTMJ Breaking Newsroom, the verdict is in.
We, the jury, find the defendant, Kimberly Zapata, guilty.
Jury finds Kimberly Zapata guilty on all four counts. The former deputy director of the Milwaukee Elections Commission of ordering 3 military absentee ballots under fake names and sending them to GOP Representative Janelle Brantian. Zapata found guilty on 1 count of misconduct in public office. That's a felony. And 3 counts of false statements to obtain vote and absentee ballots.
Milwaukee Mayor Cavalier Johnson signing legislation approving where people can protest during the RNC.
Although Mayor Johnson has passed the legislation, there are still people who might want to challenge it.
I think that we have worked in conjunction with folks who have had concerns about this. We had a community meeting where community groups were able to come out, voice their concerns, and there have been changes made to accommodate some of those concerns as well here. So I hope that that were not to happen, but I think we're following best practices and we'll be in a strong position to defend whatever lawsuit were to come our way.
From City Hall, Julian Johnson, WTMJ News.
Registration for protest time slots during the convention opens up tomorrow.
Milwaukee police seeking a vehicle and driver wanted in a pedestrian hit and run near 13th and Atkinson on Tuesday afternoon. 61-year-old pedestrian taken to the hospital for life-threatening injuries after the crash just before 2 p.m. The vehicle is a blue four-door 2006 or 7 Honda Accord with a black front bumper and extensive damage to the windshield. Also look for damage to the hood and a missing driver's side headlamp. For more details and photos of the vehicle, check out our website, WTMJ.com.
A nonprofit just pumped about $1 million into our city's election process. The organization is called Cities Forward. It's based in Washington, D.C. Milwaukee's Common Council approved a roughly $800,000 grant from the nonpartisan group on yesterday to buy new election equipment. City leaders also approved another $250,000 grant from the same organization. That money will be spent on the Get Out the Vote campaigns put on by Milwaukee's Public Library and Election Commission.
New requirements for private security guards in Milwaukee after a gas station death last August. The Milwaukee Common Council passed an ordinance that now requires private security guards to obtain a license and a bonding agreement, including a background check. Isaiah Allen was shot and killed at a gas station convenience store by a man acting as security who was not properly vetted.
No interest rate cut from the Federal Reserve. Fed Chairman says the U.S. economy remains strong, but the path forward remains uncertain.
We're strongly committed to bringing inflation down to 2% over time. That is our goal, and we will achieve that goal. Markets believe we will achieve that goal, and they should believe that, because that's what will happen over time. But we stress over time.
Consumer prices have been slightly higher than what investors hope for over the past 2 months.
With Wisconsin as its backdrop, season 21 of the Bravo reality series Top Chef premieres tonight. One of the show's 15 contestants is James Beard-nominated Milwaukee chef Dan Jacobs. Speaking to Wisconsin's Midday News, Jacobs describes the frantic nature of the competition.
There's no faking the clock. The clock is always your enemy. Especially for myself, with mobility issues, you have to kind of break yourself down into making sure you're accomplishing goals at certain times. So yeah, I mean, it's totally for real. It's breakneck.
In 2016, Jacobs was diagnosed with Kennedy's disease, a rare inherited neuromuscular disorder. Tonight's show airs at 8 o'clock on Bravo.
Coming up, the most French thing we love.
Siding and Limited, WTMJ News Time is 4:05.
This report is sponsored by Diamonds Direct. Your love, their passion.
Here's something you won't hear from any other jeweler. Right now, when you buy a diamond at Diamonds Direct, we'll give you a free gold setting for it. Yes, a 14-karat classic solitaire setting in white gold or yellow gold at no charge with any natural diamond purchase. So all your money can go toward a bigger diamond while you still get the classic look she wants in that engagement ring. Another example of Diamonds Direct's extraordinary value. Or if you want to take it up to the next level, Diamonds Direct also has a fantastic selection of halo, pave, vintage, three-stone, and other popular mountings. Or maybe she wants a designer ring, like the one she's seen on social media. Well, Diamonds Direct has those too. In fact, we are an authorized retailer for all the top designers from New York and California. Whichever setting you choose, you'll also be able to choose your finance plan. Diamonds Direct now has a wide range of finance options with attractive rates and terms up to 60 months, so you can get the ideal setting to fit your style with the ideal payment to fit your budget. Diamonds Direct, your love, our passion. Store hours, directions, and more at DiamondsDirect.com.
Hey, WTMJ's John Mercure here. If you're like me, my home has become my happy place. It's happier now thanks to CertaPro Painters. They are simply the best in the business. They will take care of the scuffs, the faded colors. They'll make your home a new home, inside or outside. They did the work at our house. It was quick, easy, and so, so affordable. Their estimates are always easy. You get a quote right away. It's simply the best in the business. Schedule your free estimate online at CertaPro.com. That's Certa with a C. When choosing a painting professional, the choice is simple. Choose happy. Choose CertaPro Painters.
Making a move from the home you have loved and cherished for so many years can not only be a challenge for you, but can also be stressful for the entire family. This is Jean Nemelvitz from Bruce's team. Let us help you start the conversation, so when the time is right, we can make the process simple and easy, just as we've done for thousands of families. Let us take you from overwhelmed to I can do this. Call 262-242-6177 or visit brucesteam.com.
Siding Unlimited, WTMJ News Time, 4:07.
French fries and French pastries don't hold a candle to America's love for the French bulldog. ABC's Sherry Preston.
They've got square heads, short noses, a compact body, and bat ears. Behold the beloved Frenchie. For the second year in a row, the American Kennel Club has named the French Bulldog the most favorite dog in America, and its popularity shows no signs of slowing down. The top five dog breeds after the Frenchie are the Lab, another perennial favorite, the Golden Retriever, the German Shepherd, and the Poodle.
America's other favorite dog breeds include the Labrador Retriever, German Shepherd, and Poodle, as Sherry mentioned. Time for a WTMJ Sports Update from the Gruber Law Office's One Call, That's All Sports Desk. It's a matchup of the two best teams in the Eastern Conference tonight, but Giannis is out against the Celtics. Coverage begins at 6 o'clock on WTMJ. No game for the Brewers today. The Cactus League season resumes tomorrow night in Arizona against the Giants. Opening day 1 week from tomorrow in New York against the Mets. Siding and Limited, WTMJ News Time is 4:09.
This report sponsored by Pella of Wisconsin. Discover Pella now, pay later at PellaWI.com.
0% interest for up to 3 years at Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. I'm Gina Della from Pella. Pella's free in-home consultations make replacing or redesigning your windows and doors easy. We go beyond just measuring and handing you a quote. We take the time to listen and educate you on all your product options. And with DesignWorks, you can see what your home will look like before you buy. Whether you're looking to replace your windows due to damage or it's time for a refresh and you'd like to revitalize your home style, choosing from Pella's wide range of windows and doors will complement your home's unique design. Pella can also customize, providing nearly endless possibilities for maximum design flexibility with dramatic sizes, custom colors, finishes, profiles, product types, and more. Order by March 31st to get 0% interest for up to 3 years. Set your free consultation at PellaWI.com.
Certain restrictions apply.
Wisconsin's afternoon news is on the air.
Broadcasting live from the Annex Wealth Management Studios at The Avenue in beautiful downtown Milwaukee. Here are your hosts, Greg Matzik and Julia Fellow.
We all miss John, but I'm sure he loves the beach right now. He's having fun on vacation. Hey, we're joined by Tori Lowe with 101.7 The Truth. Hey, I wanted to get your take because we had the mayor on last Friday, asking about school resource officers. Everybody's dodging the question. He finally got to the nitty-gritty here. We're talking about this year, not going to happen, okay? Next school year, he says that he would support if the school resource officers were outside of the school. Because with Act 12, if you didn't know, with the taxes,
right,
that was a stipulation that 25 school resource officers had to come in. So what do you think about that?
Well, I've always been a person that spoke against having officers walking around in the schools, but I never had an issue with them being outside of the school so they don't interfere with the experience, with the learning experience. And many times the mistrust of certain things that happen in our communities, especially in the north side or in my community, where there is a mistrust between law enforcement and families. So I think that you need police presence, but it shouldn't be a consistent presence while they're in the schools doing the work.
I agree. I mean, with what happened with George Floyd in 2020, the school board made it very clear how they feel about this.
Right.
And
they're speaking on the behalf of the community, because I was in a lot of those meetings. You know, I went to the state and I had to talk about these things. And what people need to understand is that we are going to always need police. But the placement, especially when young people who may be coming to school with a family member that may have, you know, or some traumatized ideas from dealing with police, that interferes with their thinking when they're in the schools. But when you get out of school, get ready to go home, great. In, no.
So it's an interesting discussion, because I think the allocation of resources is critical in the city of Milwaukee. Mm-hmm. So where do you want your police officers? Do you want them at schools? That might take a few more off the streets fighting crime during the course of the day. But does it make sense within your daily patrol to be near the school when it lets out at 3 o'clock, when all of a sudden everybody's out in the parking lot, things are happening, right? You're not in classrooms and so on. Maybe that would be a good use of their time as part of their daily
patrol.
And that's
only, what, 2 hours?
An hour,
you know, at the most, with the bulk of the students coming out, probably an hour. And then it starts to get smaller as the time goes on. So that's not a lot of time right there.
Right.
That,
so maybe
officers need to be
more part of
involved.
Their patrol day that
right.
they stop by a school versus being planted in the school all day long.
Right. You know, you got the ideal of the high school to prison pipeline and the school to prison pipeline. And we talk about these things, and especially in public school systems. And you don't want those ideas to actually be visible. I mean, if that's, you know, when you see that, you think that, and I think that that becomes distracting to students, you know. And I think that when you have police officers, if they're placed in the right space, it works well for everybody. And I think that when school lets out, or, you know, when school is probably when everybody's coming to school, but when you talk about inside, then you get to a lot of psychological ideas that may be interruptive.
I'm glad that you're talking about this. I think some people don't understand it. And it's an experience that you want, you know, our students to have a good experience, and a
right.
good experience with police.
Look, I got the baseball cards from the police when I was a kid. But as I grew older and different experiences with family members and things like that, and interactions and things personal, as I grew, I understand how that could be a distraction with them being inside the school. And like I said, I would say that, but I'll say this. There's a proper way to use the police that can be tremendously effective, and that's maybe at the beginning when everybody arrives and at the end where everybody
lives. Yeah, we need help.
I'll keep it right there.
I mean, with Capitol Drive, what's that one school right there? Is that Messimer? No?
Yeah,
Messimer.
Yep.
Oh, my goodness. The way that people are getting on the 43
right.
just buzzing by, it would be great to have an officer right
of
there.
Of course, because like I said, you know, when people see police, they tend to slow down. They tend to, I don't feel like going to jail today. And many times things happen when people can able either get in large groups, Mm-hmm. When they leave in school, I'm going to get you after school. You heard the idea, the notion that wait till school let out, I'm going to get you, you know. Or, you know, at the beginning of the day when people are coming into the school and maybe they'll get into altercations right there. But usually it's enough adult power inside the schools to handle what's going on.
Tell me about the community cleanup that's happening.
Oh, the community cleanup. Hey, look, it's Saturday, April 13th. It's the third annual community cleanup. If you want to volunteer, go to truthcommunitycleanup.com. That's truthcommunitycleanup.com. And it's also sponsored by Cousin Subs, so you get Cousin Subs at the end of the cleanup.
I think that's fantastic. I love that you're doing that. I volunteered. I think there's three different locations,
right? Three different locations. Go online when you sign up. You can choose what location you want to participate or just do them all with your boy Tory Lowe. We're going to have a great time. And look, let's beautify our city together. Paf.
Tory for mayor. How about that?
Hey. I got to get my war chest up.
There you go. Tory for governor.
I got to get that war chest up.
I love it.
Tory Lowe Show, 2 to 4, every day on 101.7 The Truth. We appreciate you, Tory. Thank you.
Hey, I appreciate you guys for having me. Have a blessed day.
416 on WTMJ.
Come see Thanalysis live from Potawatomi Casino Hotel on Friday, March 22nd.
Hey, welcome to another Thanalysis show. And who do we have coming up in today's podcast?
Be there for the first ever live show for Thanasis as he's joined by his brother, none other than the Greek freak, Giannis Antetokounmpo.
I took off my shoes and I was like, go crazy, go hoop. That's all it was.
Get your tickets now at taliveshow.com. Thanalysis live at Potawatomi Casino Hotel on March 22nd. taliveshow.com.
WTMJ's John Merck here. I love my dogs. Bella and Baxter, an important part of our family. They're kind of like kids sometimes. And like kids, they weren't always listening, but I've got it figured out now. Thanks to Matt and his teams at Sit Mean Sit Dog Training, our dogs are better behaved. They don't bark as much. They just listen better. They're happy, confident, obedient. Our house is a better house. Sit Mean Sit Dog Training turned it around for us. Let them do the same for you. You can start with a free consultation. The website is sitmeansitwaukesha.com. sitmeansitwaukesha.com.
Hey, it's WTMJ's Steve Scaviti for Universal Windows Direct. Call Universal Windows Direct today, 414-410-2000. For every two windows you buy, get two free. Buy two, get two. Buy four, get four. Buy 20, get 20. No limits. Plus, they'll upgrade your new windows to triple pane glass for free extra protection from the elements. Call 414-410-2000. Schedule your free in-home estimate today. For every two windows you buy, get the next two free. Tell them I told you to call, and you get $250 off your order. Like me, you'll be saying, I love my windows.
Increase in taxes while families are paying more for everything from gas to groceries is wrong. Milwaukee voters should oppose increase in property taxes by nearly 30% in order to provide increased funding, yet again, to Milwaukee public schools. They've already wasted nearly $1 billion in new taxpayer funding, and now they want more? They don't even have a plan on how they'll spend it. Enough is enough. Milwaukee voters should just say no.
Paid for by Enough is Enough. Vote no.
Traffic and weather. A look outside at the roads with Deb.
All right, Julia, we've got still backups on 43 southbound from before Hampton Avenue down past Capitol. Northbound side slow out of the Marquette all the way up past Keith. Southbound 41, we've got an accident now. It's just past the ramp from Appleton Avenue. It's on the left shoulder, so heads up. Things are going to start to get a little sticky around there. Westbound 94 backing up out of the Marquette interchange all the way to Hawley Road with the eastbound side slow from 84th Street through the stadium. 894 southbound also backing up out of the Zoo interchange heading down towards Lincoln Avenue. BRI's on the roads report accidents and slowdowns and road conditions to the WTMJ Hall Volkswagen traffic tip line at 414-238-9329. I'm Debbie Lozaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons paving time saver traffic.
It was not warm today. A little wind, too. Boy, it really made things chilly downtown, especially. 35 was our high downtown. We're hanging on to 34 degrees. It's going to cool off tonight to 24 under clear skies. Tomorrow, cloudy. Snow late with a high of 37. Snow on Friday morning as well. It's going to build up here a little bit, especially to the north. We'll get an update from NIS at 535. Just how much snow we can expect here in southeastern Wisconsin and the greater portion of our listening area. 34 degrees in Milwaukee. It's 419 on WTMJ.
Hey, John Merck here for my friends at Dave Dregkamp Heating. When you experience temperatures 10 degrees below zero, more than 15 inches of snow, rain showers, and sunny days in the low 40s, all in a 3-week period, it can only mean one thing. You live in Wisconsin, and that prepared you to be ready for anything. Because here in Wisconsin, anything can happen with our weather. But fear not. For over 42 years, Dave Drakamp Heating has lived here too, right by your side, ready and prepared for when anything happens. Spring, summer, fall, or winter, even when they all seem to happen at once, whenever you're experiencing a home comfort dilemma, just call the teams I trust at Dave Drakamp Heating. From free estimates for new equipment, routine maintenance to ensure your system is ready for anything, or because you simply have a question about your home comfort, call 262-367-2820. 262-367-2820. Dave Drakamp Heating, because your comfort is their family's tradition. DaveDrakamp.com.
Make this summer the best one yet. Let Fox World Travel plan your next family vacation. Whether it's a magical Disney escape, an all-inclusive resort in paradise, or a thrilling European adventure, we offer exclusive savings for your family. Enjoy exciting activities, educational experiences, or peaceful retreats where you can relax and recharge with our trusted partners like Globus Family of Brands, Disney, and Insight Vacations. Visit foxworldtravel.com or call 866-GO-FOX-GO to start planning your summer vacation today.
Who's faster, the Easter Bunny or O&H Danish Bakery? Ah, Kringle. Send that famous Kringle to any doorstep in just 2 business days. Serving Kringle will be the perfect Easter tradition. Pair that with their colorful and tasty Easter braided colored bread. Order your Easter treats online today. OHDanishBakery.com. Try all their delicious bakery made from scratch and hop into O&H Danish Bakery in Racine, Oak Creek, or Sturtevant this Easter season.
Hey, Eric Bilstead here from Wisconsin's Morning News. So you're thinking about hitting the gym, eh? Or perhaps taking up jogging again? But you're worried. That achy knee, am I right? And you have no interest in surgery. Call QC Kinetics now. QC Kinetics is the nation's leader in regenerative medicine. No surgery, no drugs, no downtime. So that means getting back to exercising, maybe even running, or even playing 18 holes again, pain-free. QC Kinetics offers an all-natural solution, no pain pills, and no risky surgery. Reclaim your mobility today. Fix that tennis swing or go back to the gym and know that you won't be dealing with achy joints afterward. Take action now and live your best life this spring and summer. Call QC Kinetics for a free consultation. QC Kinetics, 414-285-3474. That's 414-285-3474. QC Kinetics.
With Wisconsin as its backdrop, the season premiere of Top Chef 21, a Bravo series, airs tonight. 8 o'clock, the start time. This is amazing, and this is the better part of 4 years of work, Julia, to get this incredibly popular television show to use Wisconsin as its backdrop for the 14-episode season that begins tonight. 15 contestants will vie for the opportunity to be the top chef, and there's a cash prize. And you're going to see anything and everything, but all Wisconsin all the time on the 14-episode series. I'm very excited about this tonight. There's watch parties, all sorts of stuff happening in downtown Milwaukee. And it's finally here after 4 years, which is amazing.
I love this. We deserve it. We do.
So one of the contestants is Milwaukee chef Dan Jacobs. He owns a couple of restaurants in Milwaukee, one called Dan Dan, another one called Esther Ev. He is a James Beard nominated chef, has been, I believe, 6 times. And he joined us on Wisconsin's Midday News last week to talk about why he's doing this.
I've always wanted to do it. It was one of those things that I always thought I would be really good at. And then as I got older and kept trying and trying, I kind of felt like this was the last time. You know, I deal with a rare neuromuscular disease, and this was kind of like I felt like I wanted to do this to show that, you know, differently abled people or disabled people can do whatever they want. I had to use a cane, my cane a couple times. Actually, every time we were at judges' table, just because you're standing still for a while. I approached it like I would kind of a sports event, you know, where it was like I tried to get as much rest as I could or, you know, recovery as I could in between having to actually compete.
Now, if you've watched any cooking show on any channel, one thing that really stands out to me is that it seems like it is just so hyper fast moving. Always under the gun, always watching a clock. Something's always burning, right? They crank up the urgency on those shows. So I asked Dan about that. Is it really as fast-paced as it seems?
The time is real. Like, there's no faking the clock. The clock is always your enemy. And you always look at it and you're just like, I can't believe 15 minutes went by. I can't believe another 10 minutes just went by. And you have to really, like, kind of, and especially for myself, with mobility issues, you have to kind of break yourself down into making sure you're accomplishing goals at certain times. So, yeah, I mean, it's totally for real. It's breakneck.
So picture yourself, Julia, in a cooking competition, right? You know your own kitchen. You know where the ingredients are. You know how to make what you want to make. You know your oven. You know your burners and all that. And now I say, Julia, I'm going to put you on the clock. You have to make a lights-out dish in somebody else's kitchen.
On camera.
On camera.
With perfect strangers that are probably trying to sabotage you.
Right. So just all of those things that nothing is second nature when you're looking for the garlic. Like you're on a hunt for stuff. And then it's just amazing to me. So I'm very curious to see how this all plays out. And Paul Bartolotta, we had him on the midday show today as well. An instrumental figure in getting this event to Milwaukee. He is going to be a guest judge at some point. And tonight on the premiere episode, you'll see a lot of Loopy and Iris, a very popular downtown restaurant.
What time of year did they shoot this?
It looked like it was shot in the summer months.
Nice.
From what I could tell, you're not going to see much snow. Not that we've had much snow, but they chose the best weather months in Wisconsin to do the shooting.
All right. So we have the Speaker of Wisconsin State Assembly, Robin Voss, coming up right after this break. We're expecting to talk to him. We have a lot to talk about, including a recall effort that fell flat. This is Wisconsin's Afternoon News.
Time for a WTM.
This is Susan Hiller from Hiller Ford, where you can get a 2023 Ford F-150 with 1.9% 66-month FlexBuy financing. Plus, you get a factory FlexBuy bonus cash of $2,000. And with a trade-in, you get an extra factory bonus of $1,000. Ford Motor Company has awarded Hiller with their Ford President's Award for customer satisfaction 18 times, so you know you'll be treated right. Stop in and find out why so many people love to buy from Hiller Ford.
Now it's time for an Annex Wealth Management market update. All the indices finishing in the green today, and a nice rally here for the Dow, finishing up 401 points at 39,512. The NASDAQ also up today 202 points, closing at 16,369. S&P 500 up about 46 points, closing at 52,24. For sound financial advice from a fee-only fiduciary, it is Annex Wealth Management. Check out annexwealth.com. Click on the Get Started button today.
WTMJ's Vince Vitrano for Inspired Closets. Spring cleaning, let's tackle that cluttered garage. Inspired Closets helps you calm the chaos, not just inside your home, but outside. Call my friends Katie and Dan today. Let them help fix your garage with increased storage, easy-to-reach hooks and baskets, custom cabinets, and more. They come out for a free visit, listen to your needs, and use their 3D software to customize a space that helps manage your world. Inspired days start in Inspired Closets and Garages. InspiredClosetsMilwaukee.com.
Bikers need protection, not just from other drivers, but unfortunately from insurance companies too. If you've been injured in a motorcycle crash, call Gruber Law Offices today. Bikers are often blamed for causing the accident because the insurance companies simply don't want to pay. At Gruber Law Offices, we've been fighting for injured bikers and their families for more than 30 years. Trust us to fight for what you deserve. Gruber Law Offices. One call, that's all.
Hi, everybody. This is Susan Hiller from Hiller Ford on Highway 100. If you've driven past our dealership lately, you might have noticed we've been stocking up our inventory and now have a huge selection of Ford vehicles. That includes the Ford Mavericks so many people are looking for, as well as full-size Ford Broncos. Those full-size Broncos come with a factory bonus cash of $1,000. So take advantage of all the savings. Stop in today and find out why so many people love to buy from Hiller Ford.
Traffic is sponsored by the all-new Burkhart Sporting Goods.
The all-new Burkhart Sporting Goods, the Midwest's best baseball and softball training facility and retail center in New Berlin and Fox Point.
Wisconsin's Afternoon News on Wisconsin's radio station, News Radio WTMJ.
Approaching 4:30, I'm Greg Matzik. Your top story, guilty of election fraud.
I'm Julia Fellow, misprinted ballots in Sheboygan.
I'm Debbie Lazaga, and things are slowing down a little bit on 41 southbound from Appleton Avenue all the way down past Hampton. Looks like we've got the shoulder blocked with a broken down vehicle just past Hampton. Eastbound 94 slowing down coming across Highway 100 to the zoo. Then back on the brakes from 84th Street all the way through the stadium interchange. Westbound's going to be heavy out of the Marquette all the way to Hawley Road. Southbound 43 backing up from Hampton down past Keefe. Northbound is going to be slow out of the Marquette all the way up past Keefe. By the way, southbound heading over the high-rise bridge also going to be a bit heavy as well. I'm Debbie Lazaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
Chilly today, it'll be chilly tonight. A low of 25 degrees under clear skies. Cloudy tomorrow with a high of 37. Snow late could impact your Friday afternoon or Friday morning commute, I should say. Friday's high 37. It's 34 degrees in Milwaukee. At 4:30 from the WTMJ Breaking Newsroom, the verdict is in.
We, the jury, find the defendant, Kimberly Zapata, guilty.
Former Milwaukee Election Commission Deputy Director Kimberly Zapata found guilty of misconduct in public office, a felony, and three misdemeanor counts of election fraud. Milwaukee Elections Commission Executive Director Claire Woodall on the stand.
She was frustrated that people like Representative Branchon continue to focus on what they consider election fraud issues that aren't real, and that this is a real potential security issue that she wanted to bring to her attention.
So what did Ms. Zapata tell you she did?
That she made up three voters.
Zapata will be sentenced on May 2nd.
The group of Milwaukeeans for Affordable Housing imploring residents to vote no on the proposed $252 million Milwaukee Public Schools referendum. Robin Kitzrow, a former MPS principal, says the district is being intentionally vague with their plans.
The MPS district needs a comprehensive plan to improve the future of our children.
Superintendent Dr. Keith Polsley told Wisconsin's Afternoon News that the district intends to use the funds to maintain new and existing services.
From the first referendum, where we were able to add back art, music, physical education, library media specialists, smaller class sizes, counselors, and we are maintaining that.
The referendum appears on the Milwaukee residents' ballots April 2nd.
Facing a $3.6 million budget shortfall due to accounting errors, the Glendale River Hills School District plans to discuss the ongoing issues with the community tonight. TMJ4's Sydney Orr.
On Tuesday, we know the school board talked about the potential for staff cuts for the next school year in order to make up for the shortfall. Some parents say they feel there has been a lack of transparency so far. The business manager and superintendent have submitted their resignations, and the district hired a financial firm to help discuss options for funding.
As a mother with a special ed kid, it's like, do I need to find another school district for her? Do we need to sell our house and move?
When we thought it through, we weren't going anywhere. We like the teachers too much. We like the people too much. A little disappointed.
The meeting is at 6:30 tonight at Glen Hills Middle School.
Embezzlement funds spent at the casino. Former Milwaukee Department of Public Works employees Kyle Hepp and Kelly Whitmore Bailing reportedly embezzled hundreds of thousands of dollars from the city by underreporting sales of DPW equipment. Urban Milwaukee tells WTMJ the federal plea agreement shows that they sold a bulk of equipment to an individual with just the initials they showed, RG, at the Central Repair Garage on Canal.
The report doesn't suggest that that individual is going to face criminal charges, but it does, and I'm doing the air quotes right now, note he made a significant profit because he was getting stuff for under market value and reselling it.
If convicted, Hepp and Whitmore Bailing face up to 15 years in prison and more than $350,000 in restitution and fines.
Siding Unlimited, WTMJ News Time is 4:33.
All right, we have Republican Speaker Robin Voss joining us by phone. Mr. Speaker, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Julia. How are you?
Good. Wanted to talk to you with Greg next to me about the effort to do a recall. It's fallen flat.
I have to tell you, it doesn't break my heart. So we know that the folks who organized this recall were really focused on things that happened, three or four years ago. They were worried about what happened in the 2020 election. I think we all know there were some challenges, but we are way beyond that now. They have gotten to the point where they can't let go of the past, and they are just obsessed with it. And we now see that the recall, we're filing all of our paperwork tomorrow, but we see that they had less than half of the signatures that they reported, nowhere near the number to actually trigger the recall, with all kinds of issues related to fraud. And that's really what's disappointing, because for all of us, who care about election integrity. The idea of saying that we're going to allow felons to do things illegally and that we're going to have fraudulent signatures should concern us all.
And Speaker Voss, one of my big takeaways from this whole effort is that you guys are all on the same side, right? It's just like it's Republicans and Republicans fighting within the party. And I'm sure it happens on the Democratic side, too. But what does it say about the state of the party that, you know, those supposedly fighting for the same thing can't seem to play nice in the sandbox?
Well, they are fighting for the same thing in some cases, but they were very upfront in saying they're not Republicans. They actually worked with Democrats to circulate the nomination papers and invited their help. We know that the paid signature gatherers look like they were mostly Democratic operatives who came into Wisconsin and were hired by somebody, presumably the recall group, to be able to circulate the paperwork. So I think that in the past they might have said they were Republican, but I don't know many Republicans who work with Democrats to defeat another Republican. It doesn't make much sense to me.
Right. And the opposition group, they said they collected 10,000 recall signatures, fell way short of that. The Elections Commission now found that more than 1,000 of those signatures were not valid at all. And Speaker Voss, I wanted to talk to you about this. The opposition group was saying they had nothing to do with this. So who did? The statement is not even a political one here. Whether you've known Speaker Voss for more than a decade like me or 10 minutes, you know that he crosses every T and dots every I. So it seems like the opposition is trying to say that your camp is behind those fake signatures, which is just wild.
Well, it's just a bold-faced lie. I mean, this is one of those things. In politics, sometimes you launch an effort and you're successful. Other times you launch an effort and you fall flat like this one did, and you have to own it. Julia, that's the difference. They told people and they submitted the signatures from people who turned them into them. I don't know about you, but if you thought there was any kind of a fraud or challenge, you wouldn't submit those signatures, which is what's so frustrating in the fact that they say that somehow I would have hired people, wasted money to collect signatures, to put it in to not even be close to the number. That is just stupid on the face. So obviously we weren't involved in any way other than trying to get people to not sign the recall, which was our entire effort, to make sure people knew that this was a waste of taxpayer money, and it certainly wouldn't help elect conservatives in the fall. So I think most people in Racine County listened. We had a very small number sign, and if you look at that, we have got so many examples of people who had a fraudulent signature. They went through the signatures before they're even online, and their brother was on there, their mom was on there. I mean, we had a case where someone had dementia, she can't even write her own name, but her signature was on the ballot or on the form. So I think we just have a bunch of examples that are moving forward. Now, there's actually a website that's going to be launched. It'll be coming out tomorrow, where you will actually be able to go online, type in your name, and be able to see if you had a fraudulent signature on there. I think that's really important for us to go forward. So, again, the people who organized the recall need to take ownership for the mistake that they made by doing a half-hearted attempt and really doing it very poorly, employing Democrats to get it done in the end.
Oh, wow. That takes a lot of work to do. With the recall Walker campaign that happened, there was an online form where you could search a name. So that's interesting. And prosecutors in Racine County say they've received calls from people, you know, they have already looked and they said, I have nothing to do with this. Somebody came in to have me sign. I never did. So it looks like you have 10 days from the time it was submitted to challenge it. And from what you were saying at the beginning of this conversation, it looks like you are.
Oh, yeah, we're going through the challenge process. We actually will be filing all that tomorrow, so our 10 days is up tomorrow. We had over 50 volunteers taking a ton of time to actually enter in every single name. Now, the one thing I can tell you, Julia, is that we had a bill that passed the Assembly which would have required cursive to be taught in schools. Let me tell you, going through 10,000 signatures, it would be great if people had legible handwriting. But we did our very best to data enter every name in. And we found, I think it was over 300 or 400 duplicates. We found people who clearly didn't live inside the district. That was more than half of the names that were not even in the district. And then after we did the analysis, we hired private investigators who are looking at every one of the signature gatherers. And we found that there are felons on the list. As a felon, you're not allowed to submit signatures. It's one of the prohibitions, just like you can't vote. So we think there's going to be a pretty clear-cut case that the people who put together this recall didn't really know what they were doing. paid professionals to do a half-hearted job and ultimately failed in their effort because of their own ineptitude and, you know, half-hearted effort to get this done.
Speaker Voss, we expect to see President Biden's name on the ballot in November alongside Donald Trump's. Do you believe Trump can beat Biden in the 2024 election?
Yeah, Greg. I mean, I think he can. I mean, who knows if he will? But the question really comes down to, we have two candidates running for president, and I think most Americans would say that neither one of the two is their favorite candidate out of 360 million Americans. But I think what people can also say is we have a choice between two men. It's not between perfection. It's not between, you know, who's going to be the person that's the best at tweeting or who's going to be the person that's best at giving a speech. We need the leader of the free world. And to me, when you look at the policies that we had under Donald Trump, where the border was more secure, we had a lower tax burden, the price of gas and groceries was a lot less than it was now. We had a country where people stood up and were proud around the world that they were Americans, versus where we are now, where the border is being overrun, we have rampant inflation, taxes are trying to go, the Democrats are trying to raise taxes every way that they can. I think most Americans would look and say the world was better under Donald Trump. Now, that doesn't mean he's going to win. But when you're given a choice between two men, you have to make the best decision for the country. And I think most Wisconsinites, when they look at the balance, will say things are better under Donald Trump than they are today.
Republican Speaker Robin Voss, always good to talk to you. Thank you for your generous time and joining us on Wisconsin's Afternoon News.
Thanks for having me on, guys. Have a good day.
Thank you.
441 on WTMJ, president of the MMAC, Dale Coinga, joins us in studio coming up in just a few minutes.
This report is sponsored by Diamonds Direct. Your love, their passion.
Let's listen in on a modern-day marriage proposal. The players lift their smartphones. The young man pledges his true love to the woman of his dreams. She accepts. They exchange kissing emojis. There are some hearts. Very nice. Well, look at this. He's putting his phone down. I don't believe it. He's got a box from Diamonds Direct. Now she puts her phone down. Oh, unbelievable! That, folks, shows how special a diamond from Diamonds Direct is. Two people have put their phones down. He slips the Diamonds Direct diamond on her finger. She kisses him! Human contact, ladies and gentlemen! Who knew a Diamonds Direct diamond was capable of revolutionizing the virtual universe? And look at this! Her phone is ringing and she's still looking at her Diamonds Direct diamond. Oh, what's next? Tweets from actual birds? Amazing things really do happen when you give her a diamond from Diamonds Direct. Come in today and see how we can help you download Real Emotion. Details, store hours, and more at DiamondsDirect.com. Your love, our passion.
Hey, WTMJ's John Mercier here. If you've got water in your house, you need Guthrie and Fry. We've got their water softener. We get their salt delivery. We've got reverse osmosis that protects the water in our house. They've got the best people. They've got the best products. It's Guthrie and Fry. They treat their clients like their family. I feel that every time they're in our house, you need Guthrie and Fry. Fixed rental rates, convenient salt delivery programs. It's gfwater.com.
Better water makes a big difference. Guthrie and Fry.
An intimate evening with David Foster and Catherine McPhee. Performing hit after hit, live on stage. Somewhere. May 2nd at the Pabst Theater. Tickets are on sale now at PabstTheaterGroup.com. Don't miss David Foster and Catherine McPhee together live.
AccuNet Mortgage is an equal housing lender. NMLS ID 255368.
Steve and Ashley heard our radio ads over the years, and when it came time to buy their first home, clicked on the blue button. One of our senior loan consultants, Brad, sent them a credit-verified pre-approval the same day and then upgraded to a rock-solid, fully verified and guaranteed pre-approval shortly thereafter. They made a couple offers without success, and then Brad told them about AccuNet's new property-specific pre-approval, where we might be able to include those magic words, no appraisal required. When they wrote their next offer, several thousand dollars over asking to make sure someone else didn't end up sleeping in their dream home, their property-specific rock-solid guaranteed pre-approval included that most powerful phrase, no appraisal required, and the sellers picked Steve and Ashley's offer over several others. If you think all mortgage lenders and pre-approvals are the same, think again. Go with a local mortgage lender that has the tools and know-how to help you win and save money, too. Click on the blue button today at accunet.com.
You know, it feels good when I find something really cool and get a great deal on it. But it feels even better when I know that the money I spend actually goes directly to helping others. That's why I shop at St. Vincent de Paul, because I always find the best bargains, and the money I spend stays in Milwaukee County to help fight hunger and eliminate poverty. St. Vincent de Paul thrift stores on Highway 100 in Layton in Greenfield and 23rd in Lincoln in Milwaukee.
Ooh, you're gonna love it, St. Vincent de Paul.
Traffic is sponsored by Ken Michaels Furniture in Brookfield, Greenfield, or downtown Milwaukee. Milwaukee Mattress, where top quality mattresses are priced hundreds less than premium national mattress brands. Found exclusively at Ken Michaels Furniture in Brookfield, Greenfield, and downtown Milwaukee.
Traffic and weather, it's 4:45 on WTMJ. Debbie, how are things heating up on the roads?
Well, they are slowing down a bit. Eastbound 94, right through the Gerke's Corners area. We're seeing backups starting at about Springdale Road all the way past Barker. Then we've got some more backups on eastbound from 92nd Street all the way through to Holly Road, then back on the brakes through the stadium. Westbound's backing up out of the Marquette all the way to Holly Road. We've got some backups, pockets of heavy traffic on southbound 894, I should say, from the Zoo Interchange down towards Lincoln, and southbound 43, heavy from Hampton, pretty much past Keefe, and then again right through the Marquette. I'm Debbie Lozaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
Clear skies tonight, but cold, a low of 25. Clouds on the increase tomorrow, 37-year high. Expect some snow late. And according to Brian Desnansky, it looks like it's going to affect your Friday morning commute. Whatever snow falls tomorrow late will be falling on the morning of Friday as you wake up. So be careful when you are on the roads on Friday. Maybe get out a little early or whatever you need to do to be safe on the roads. High of 37 on Friday. It's 34 degrees in Milwaukee at 4:46.
Metropolitan Milwaukee Association of Commerce, Dale Coyne joins us live in studio. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Okay, I'm going straight to it.
Go right at it.
We're going to go right into the MPS referendum.
Yeah, it's a big deal.
I mean, it would bring up about more than $400 on a $200,000 home. We're talking more than $250 million referendum. We had the superintendent on, Keith Posley. He was talking about how this was just to keep everything as is.
Mm-hmm.
That's what he was describing. But you are definitely, your organization is against it. Tell me why.
Well, as is the former superintendent of MPS, Bill Andrikopoulos came out against it very strongly. And he's been on the inside. He said, you can't keep doing this. And, you know, I brought for you guys here, I know your viewers can't see it, but if you look at Midwestern cities, the amount of property taxes paid as a percentage of value, the only Midwestern city that has a worse scenario than us as of right now before this referendum is Detroit. And the reason for that is Detroit keeps raising their property taxes. People are vacating Detroit. The numbers of empty homes increase, more evictions, more empty homes, more crime, and then you just get the death spiral. So this is the largest tax increase in Wisconsin history. And it is substantially larger than the last referendum of $88 million. This is $250 million. And renters and homeowners have no idea the huge impact it's going to have. And most families don't have $400 in America ready for an emergency. This referendum increases your taxes by more than $400.
It's interesting that you mentioned renters, Dale, because I think if you're a property owner and you own a multifamily sort of unit, apartment complex, you might be thinking to yourself, well, I don't have to pay property taxes. All good. But whoever does own that building is likely going to pass that on to you, and your rent is likely to go up. Is that accurate?
MMEC did a survey of property owners, single-family home property owners, apartment buildings. We asked them that exact question is, how many of you are going to pass this off to your renters? And they all say, 90% of them say we're going to pass 90% of this off to our renters. I mean, that's just the way it is. They have mortgages themselves. They're going to pass it on. So this is going to hit renters significantly. And so I think people usually don't connect that. I mean, if you look at the question that will be before voters doesn't even mention property taxes. It's a very legal question about revenue limits and dollar amounts over certain years. What it does not clearly say, and we've done polling that says this, if you ask the referendum question, people say, oh, yeah. If you rephrase the question and say, will you pay higher property taxes and rent? They say, no, I will not. And so a lot of this about is educating voters. There's a great event today outside City Hall. Dozens and dozens of parents We said the former superintendent is against this for MPS. There was also an MPS principal there who said, this is not what the middle class in Milwaukee need. The middle class in Milwaukee need a middle class, and you're going to gut the middle class, and we want to be here and want to have good schools. We want to have a plan for good schools, and we want to have affordable living in Milwaukee.
So what's the solution for MMAC? Because it looks like if we don't get it, then he said there'd be, at least at the school level, up to 13% cuts.
Yeah, well, whatever happens, if the referendum passes, then MMAC is going to do a deep dive with all sorts of stakeholders that are part of the association, other not-for-profits, and we're going to say, okay, how do we now work with them to improve results? Where do we go from here? If the referendum fails, we will then work with them on, hey, we have business minds, we have consultants, we have ideas, there's things you could do. I mean, if you look at the number of buildings they have per students, they have 25% less students in each building. I mean, there's buildings out there with 140, 150 kids. So there's a way to still do, and they don't have much neighborhood schools now, but there's a way to do, have school students closer to their buildings, still have a school choice element within the public school system, and still be more efficient, effective with those buildings. I mean, there's a lot of school buildings out there where the second, third floor is completely empty. So in each one of those buildings is not only more heat and gas and insurance, but you have a lot of administrative costs that are on top of that. So we're talking about this referendum over $20,000 per student. You know, if a classroom is 20 students, that's $400,000. Where's that money going? That's not going to teachers. I mean, we all agree that teachers deserve more money. Teachers' aides deserve more money. We need more money for special education in Wisconsin. There's no debate about this. What we're asking is, how does that happen? Because with the numbers we're seeing as business people, it doesn't make sense. And that's why we're opposed, is we don't see a plan that makes sense. And while you're doing this, you're gutting the middle class in Milwaukee.
MMAC President Dale Coinga joining us on Wisconsin's Afternoon News. There's an increased demand for health care in our state, and there is a shortage of health care workers for the segment of the population that is requiring additional care. How do we solve this issue?
Well, I mean, there's a lot of different ways to solve this. I'll just give you a couple of them. First of all, just to say what the problem is a numerator and denominator problem. And what I mean by that is we have significantly more people that need health care because we're getting older. We're getting older, and older people, and not to be Captain Obvious, but here we are, older people need more healthcare. And meanwhile, you have a burnout in healthcare, less and less people doing healthcare. My wife is in healthcare. She's a nurse at Children's Hospital. I've seen it. I know it. Like, and what they're doing is there's so much pressure on our healthcare providers is they're getting burned out. And so they're like, maybe not quitting, but doing less hours. And because there's a need for healthcare workers, places will afford them less hours because they have to, because they can't get rid of these people. They can't just say goodbye, so they're more flexible, which is good. But we need more people to go to college or technical degrees in this healthcare field. So, I mean, a lot of this actually comes back to our previous MPS conversation, is we need an effective school system so this talent pool that we have that's not getting out of high school is able to get out of high school and get to our great schools like University of Wisconsin-Milwaukee and our tech colleges like MATC and WCTC to get their learned skills. Because we literally, physically need people to provide health care for the health of the community.
This is fascinating stuff. And we were reading in this a little bit earlier today about the opportunity to retire in the state of Wisconsin, right? Talk about a natural segue. People are living longer. And yes, there is a greater demand for health care. I don't know if the retiree numbers are higher than they've ever been in Wisconsin, but my parents are retired and are in the state of Wisconsin, also choosing to work so they stay active.
Right.
New studies indicate just how much you will need to have saved up to retire in the state of Wisconsin. Put it into perspective. Where does Wisconsin rank on that state list?
Well, we're middle of the pack of the 50 states. We're middle of the pack. I don't think we want to lead the pack, and I'm not trying to disparage. Every place has its own community and its own, you know, beauty and everything. Number one is West Virginia. And the reason West Virginia is number one is just cost of living, right? But do you want to retire in West Virginia? Not if you're a golfer, not if you like lakes, not if you like the things Wisconsin has. And Wisconsin has a lot of great things. So if you look at like a golf magazine would say, Wisconsin's a great place to retire because it's a great place for golf, right? So there's all sorts of different criteria. But for purely on an economic level, when you look at your 401k, when you look at the present value of your pension payments, and you say, I have this much to live, Wisconsin's the middle of the pack. Unfortunately, I know it's a big number. And I'm also with you with a jaw dropping on this. With four kids and a lot of financial commitments. It says in Wisconsin you need $826,000 to retire right now. Now, majority of people, 37% of workers, say it's very unlikely they'll achieve the target of what the numbers are in their state. But it's just a, you know, a reality check that we're getting older. We need more health care. And by the way, it's expensive to retire if you want to maintain your cost of living. And so save, save, save. And hopefully those markets keep going up.
Yeah, absolutely 100%. Right. So I think about flexible work hours at, you know, a nice, you know, maybe white collar kind of location, you know, mm-hmm. but not manufacturing. Flexible working hours is coming to manufacturing?
It is. And this is the sign of the times, because when we think there's so many things about manufacturing that are changing, and they're changing so fast. But it used to be manufacturing was dark, dirty, and dangerous. If you go to a manufacturing plant right now, it's actually really clean. It's not dirty. It can't be dirty, especially a lot of like the medical stuff we do here. It's some of the cleanest places in the Milwaukee area are our manufacturing sites. There's a place that does medical stuff here in Wisconsin and MGS, and they are clean as could be because they have to, because it's going in people's bodies. But also the hour-wise is that they also are having issues with getting workers, and so you have to come to the market. You have to go to them, and if they say, hey, I'm willing to work, you know, 6 hours for 6 days a week, or you know, 4 days a week, you come to them and you fit that in. And fortunately, new automation and robotics, a lot of companies are able to figure this out, so it's getting more and more flexible, which is good.
Always good stuff. MMAC President Dale Coinga joining us here. It's 4:56 on WTMJ. Dale, thank you. We'll see you again next
time.
Thank you. See ya.
News is next after business headlines right here on WTMJ.
Papa Luigi's Pizza in Cudahy plans to expand its kitchen space by 1,100 feet to provide staff more room to serve customers and a high demand for pizza that can become as much as 400 pizzas on weekend nights. It will be the restaurant's third expansion since it opened 42 years ago. Milwaukee County's pursuit of more federal grants includes applying later this year for money to build a new international terminal at Milwaukee Mitchell International Airport. If the county can secure federal construction grants next year, it could mean more international flights into and out of Mitchell Airport as early as 2026 or 2027. Moore Construction Services purchases the former Schwabenhof property in Menomonee Falls, which served its last fish fry in 2022. Moore Construction plans to use the 21.5 acres purchased for industrial development and potentially to reopen the restaurant. I'm Linda Spice with MilwaukeeBusinessJournal.com on News Radio WTMJ.
WTMJ, W277CV, and WKTI HD2 Milwaukee from the Annex Wealth Management Studios. This is News Radio WTMJ, a Good Karma brand station.
Business headlines sponsored by the Pfister Hotel. Make your reservations today. Visit thepfisterhotel.com.
For over 130 years, the Pfister Hotel in downtown Milwaukee has been delighting guests with impeccable service and luxurious accommodations. Celebrate your next special occasion with a stay at the Pfister. Enjoy fine dining at its acclaimed restaurants and pamper yourself with a service from the Well Spa and Salon. Experience the hotel's afternoon tea program or take in live music with the best views of the city from Blue, the 23rd floor cocktail lounge. There's always a reason to celebrate with the Pfister Hotel. Make your reservations today at the Pfister. Hotel.com.
Do you check your savings account and wonder if you're even saving at all? At Town Bank, we view banking differently and actually want to see your savings grow. With our amazing new CD rates, you can now earn even more, so you can sit back and relax. Stop banking the same way, expecting different results, and start earning more. Go to townbank.us/locknewrates or visit a Town Bank branch nearest you today. Bank differently with Town Bank. Member FDIC.
Since 1955, Geist Garage Doors has been the trusted authority in Wisconsin. Hey, it's Greg Bancic. Don't let a busted garage door get you down. Give my friends at Geist a call. Doors and openers for every budget are available, and they'll even build custom designs to meet your exact needs. Check out geistdoors.com or call 262-784-4250. Or do what I did. Check out their amazing showroom in Brookfield featuring hundreds of doors, openers, and their custom design room. Wherever you are in southeast Wisconsin, don't think twice. Call Geist.
Don't think twice. Call Geist.
Find what you love, love what you find. A Total Wine and More, there's so much waiting for you. Spirits and beer, thousands of wines. Walk right through the door, it's all here to explore. With guides in the know and prices so low, it just might blow your mind. You're gonna find what you love and love what you find.
Drink responsibly, B21.
When Cynthia came to TurboTax, she had just launched her new side gig.
a true crime podcast.
I'm a first-rate detective with a golden voice.
As her TurboTax expert, I made her second income count by guaranteeing 100% accurate filing and her maximum refund.
What did she do with that refund? Find out next week.
Switch to Intuit TurboTax and make your moves count. See guarantee details at TurboTax.com/guarantees. Experts only available with TurboTax Live.
Griffin is your one-stop shop this March. For only $179.95, we offer an all-exclusive package to spruce up your ride. Get an oil change, tire rotation, air filter, wiper blades, multi-point inspection, battery check, and heat inspection. Griffin, your spring drive starts here.
I'm Brett Machke, and you're due for service.
Bridgelands.
Traffic is sponsored by TabakAttorneys.com. Veterans benefits denied? Call Tabak for the payback. Tabak Law fights for those who fought for us. If you're a vet and have been wrongfully denied the VA benefits you're entitled to, call Tabak for the payback. TabakAttorneys.com.
Stay up to date with your trusted and relevant source in news, sports, traffic, and weather. We are Wisconsin's radio station. News Radio 620, WTMJ, Milwaukee.
It's 5 o'clock. I'm Greg Matzik, and for John Mercure, this is Wisconsin's Afternoon News for Wednesday, March 20th. Your top story, demolition finally beginning at Northridge.
I'm Julia Fellow. Ballot fraud trial. The verdict is in.
I'm Debbie Lozaga. Southbound on 41, backing up from Appleton Avenue all the way down past Capitol Drive. You'll be back on the brakes once you get out of the Zoo Interchange onto 894 southbound, heading down towards Lincoln. So heads up with that. We've got eastbound 94, heavy ride in Waukesha County from Highway 164 almost to about Brookfield Road. And then back on the brakes from 84th Street through the stadium. Southbound 43, a little heavy from Hampton down past Keefe. Northbound is backed up out of the Marquette all the way up to Keefe. I'm Debbie Lozaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
Increasing clouds late, chilly tonight, low of 24 near the lake, 18 inland. Thursday, mostly cloudy, snow late with a high of 35. It's 34 degrees in Milwaukee. At 5:01 from the WTMJ Breaking Newsroom, demolition begins at the former Boston store at Northridge Mall. Milwaukee Mayor Cavalier Johnson on the future plans for the site.
There's no grand plan just yet. But what I do know is that that mall should come down. So it's our intention to take that down and create a new space for a new opportunity to happen. I don't know what that is just yet, but certainly it'll be better than what is presently happening at that site right now.
City of Milwaukee took full possession of the site from U.S. Bank in January.
A former FedEx employee charged after firing dozens of shots inside a Menominee Falls facility. Isaiah Dorsey of Waukesha faces charges of felony armed burglary with a dangerous weapon, criminal damage to property, and resisting arrest. Officers say Dorsey entered the facility near Pilgrim Road and County Line Road in Menominee Falls with a handgun, fired two dozen shots inside the building, and amazingly, no one was injured. His next hearing is set for Monday.
Governor Tony Evers signing a bill aimed at jumpstarting creation of an electric vehicle charging network along Wisconsin highways. The Wisconsin Department of Transportation will receive more than $78 million in federal funds under President Biden's bipartisan infrastructure law to begin construction of those charging stations. Users of the charging stations would be charged 3 cents per kilowatt hour tax.
Misprints on election ballots in the city of Sheboygan. The city discovered two printing errors on its April 2nd ballots. It advises voters to access the correct ballots online. The correct ballots online separate the municipal judge section and the aldermanic section with clear instructions to vote for one in each category. There's a second misprint, too, on the ballot, but the city did not specify what that error was.
Another Wisconsin college is in danger of closing its doors.
Northland College in Ashland says they need to raise $12 million by April 3rd, or the school will begin the process of closing after this academic year. A review by the Board of Trustees and college leadership confirmed the school does not have sufficient resources to continue programs and operations beyond this year. Northland is the latest in a series of Wisconsin campuses in danger of shutting down. Last week, UW-Milwaukee announced that it will close its branch campus in Waukesha in the spring of 2025. Adam Roberts, WTMJ News.
We, the jury, find the defendant Kimberly Zapata guilty.
Former Milwaukee Election Commission Deputy Director Kimberly Zapata found guilty of misconduct in public office, a felony, and three misdemeanor counts of election fraud. She will be sentenced on May 2nd. Coming up, new options for women's health care.
Siding and Limited, WTMJ News Time is 5:04.
This report is sponsored by Diamonds Direct. Your love, their passion.
What's wrong with Rick? He's kind of spacey today.
That's Rick's identical twin, Scott. He's not used to answering to Rick.
What's going on?
Rick asked me to keep it secret, but he asked his twin to cover his shift so he could go to Diamonds Direct to shop.
But this is a jewelry store.
Yeah, I know. But the prices and selection are so much better at Diamonds Direct. Rick doesn't want the boss to get suspicious, so Scott's here in case the boss sees Rick at Diamonds Direct.
But that would mean that the boss is at Diamonds Direct too?
Yeah, we have a lot of secrets.
You never know who you'll run into at Diamonds Direct. With unbeatable direct importer prices, the highest quality diamonds, the most sought-after designer rings, the best customer service, the strongest guarantees in the industry, it's just a no-brainer.
You think if Scott had a mustache, would he look like me?
No.
Go where everyone else goes. Diamonds Direct. Your love, our passion.
Well, what if I shaved?
Still no.
For store hours, directions, and more, go to DiamondsDirect.com.
People saw me and assumed I couldn't work. They only saw a disability, but I was ready to work. I am dependable, trainable, and productive. Then someone decided to believe in me and say yes.
And once you say yes, ThinkAbility Wisconsin will be there, providing transition and workforce support for people with disabilities and their employers to help shape a better future for all. It all starts when you say yes. Join the movement at thinkabilitywi.org.
WTMJ's Vince Vitrano here. We agree, right? Potholes stink. Now, recent weather means this could be one of the worst years yet. Johnson & Sons Paving is up to the challenge. This team has over two decades' experience. When potholes pop up in your asphalt, Johnson & Sons Paving will patch them up or replace the whole parking lot. Take a look at JohnsonAndSonsPaving.com. Sign a parking lot paving contract before May 31st, and you might just get me out on the job site working with the crew. Find full contest details at WTMJ.com/contests.
Setting Unlimited WTMJ News Time, 5:06. While some states are limiting or restricting access to abortions, others are expanding reproductive health options for women. ABC's Michelle Franzen.
The over-the-counter O-pill is now available online. Walgreens says starting this week, it will begin stocking the birth control pill at its 8,700 stores nationwide. The price, just under $20 for a one-month pack. The FDA-approved pill has been used by women for decades, but a prescription is no longer needed. And Walgreens and CVS say their pharmacies have started dispensing the progesterone blocker mifepristone in select states where abortion is legal, including New York, Illinois, and Nevada. Michelle Franzen, ABC News.
Time for a WTMJ sports update from the Gruber Law Offices. One call, that's all sports desk. It's a matchup of the two best teams in the Eastern Conference tonight. The Bucks take on the Boston Celtics. Giannis will not play, however, sitting out due to injury. Coverage gets underway at 6 o'clock on WTMJ. And the Brewers resume Cactus League play tomorrow night against the Giants from Arizona, where they've won five straight games. And our next broadcast, or our first broadcast, I should say, of regular season baseball for the Brewers, 1 week from tomorrow.
Siding Unlimited, WTMJ News Time, 5:08.
Sponsored by Grandview Homes, the name you know, the name you trust, GrandviewHomes.com.
We asked people why they sold their homes to Grandview Homes instead of using a real estate agent.
We looked at a few businesses that purchase homes, and Grandview seemed to be the one that had it together. Not only did we receive a fair offer, but we were able to take as much time as we needed and could leave the house a mess.
Whether you have a hard-to-sell home, want a stress-free sale, or simply need to sell your home fast, Grandview Homes is the name you know and the name you can trust. Visit GrandviewHomes.com to discover the easiest and fastest way to sell a home.
Vince Vitrano for Absolute Comfort, HVAC and Electrical, joined by Nicole, who along with her husband Brent owns the company. Nicole, why is now a good time to have you out looking at my air conditioner?
Because we want you to get to know us before you have an HVAC or electrical emergency. We will provide maintenance to your AC system so it's ready to operate efficiently on those warm spring days and hot summer nights.
And they are coming. Absolute Comfort, HVAC and Electrical, 262-664-9284, Absolute Comfort, WI.com.
Wisconsin's Afternoon News is on the air, broadcasting live from the Annex Wealth Management Studios at The Avenue in beautiful downtown Milwaukee. Here are your hosts, Greg Matzik and Julia Fellow.
So happy you made it to Wednesday with us. Thank you so much for joining us at 5:09. Looks like John won't be back until Monday. He's having a good time off. He deserves it, though. Hey, I wanted to talk about Washington County Executive Josh Shulman. He joined the Political Power Hour to share a special incentive program to get people to buy a home there. They really want this to happen. It's called Heart and Homestead. It's going to be launched on April 2nd. So anyone 18 or older thinking about building or buying a home that's worth under $420,000 in Washington County can earn up to $10,000 of the purchase price or $20,000, whichever is less, by volunteering. Here he is.
And the way that it works, simplistically, is you get this down payment incentive, and you can earn it back. So you can volunteer at local nonprofits or at your church, or you can donate to those organizations. And if you donate money, 70 cents of every dollar goes to pay down the incentive. If you donate your time, an average of $25 an hour is reduced for every hour that you work at that nonprofit or church or whatever organization in Washington County.
So you get this incentive and you have to earn it back through volunteering and having a stake in where you live, which I love, and so do nonprofits who need help.
You can imagine from the nonprofit groups, they're just chomping for more volunteers. Volunteer fire companies are a really good example. They're really struggling. When I was in the Village of Richfield, they had 76 volunteers or 78 volunteers. That was 10 years ago. Today, they're down to like 28. So, you know, an organization like that, and then you think about the YMCA or the Boys and Girls Club or so many others.
You know, some people need this money. And listen, Washington County needs families.
How do we bring the next generation back to Washington County? We've always been not great at keeping and retaining our kids. They go off, serve in the military, go to college, and we don't do a very good job of bringing them back. So, you know, our first initiative here is to try to help bring them back, and hopefully they bring a friend from Milwaukee County or Cook County or Kansas City or somewhere across the country and really, really help grow Washington County and keep our schools strong, keep our volunteer organizations strong and our community strong.
See, that's what I'm thinking about, Greg, is that if they are losing people in Washington County, they need to be able to fund a lot of things, police, fire, and the school districts. It's not cheap. You know?
No, there's no doubt about that. And I think what Washington County is kind of done here, if you pay attention via social media, they are going after those who live in Milwaukee County who might be frustrated with the ever-growing tax base, property taxes that are notoriously higher than other counties in our district, especially neighboring counties, per $100,000 of home value. And if the MPS referendum goes through, you might have others who decide, you know what, maybe a neighboring county is best for me, be it Waukesha, Ozaukee, or Washington. So they're trying to recruit, thinking that some may choose to leave Milwaukee County because of taxes.
So if you volunteer with participating agencies, you'll earn $25 an hour for every hour that you donated in time. And let's say that you donate $1,000 or something like that. 70 cents for every dollar that you donate will go towards that amount. So I think it's really cool. If you want to Google Washington County, Wisconsin Heart and Homestead Program, you'll be able to find it. It's 5:13 on WTMJ.
Be greeted by an owner at America's largest employee-owned jewelry store.
Welcome to Kessler's.
Hey, WTMJ's John Mercure here. I've been dealing with neck and back pain for quite some time, and I think I finally got a handle on it. It's because of the work I'm doing with Connect Chiropractic. Dr. Alex and his teams at Connect Chiropractic do it a different way. No twisting, cracking, or popping. None of that stuff. Long-term care focus on total wellness. Multiple locations in the Milwaukee area. They do it different. They're going to help take care of you big time. Help the hopeless that need help. It's all about the help. It's Connect Chiropractic.
Stay and play in Lake Geneva, the Midwest's premier golf destination. With 10 challenging courses for all abilities and skill levels, breathtaking views, crystal clear lakes, and rolling fairways. Enjoy an all-inclusive golf getaway with luxurious lodging, distinctive dining, and a relaxing spa. Plan a group golf outing, a corporate event, or a weekend getaway with friends or family. For course information and more, go to visitlakegeneva.com. Lake Geneva. It's always been the place
for legendary golf.
Hi, folks. Cindy Storm Fisher and Julie Coombs here at Storm Fisher Investment Group with just one question. Are you happy with how your investments are growing? We've been helping people just like you for over 40 years, and we'd be happy to help you.
We have no agenda, no quotas to meet, and great relationships are our business. If you're looking for an advisory relationship like you've never had before, call us. Let's see if it's a great fit. Storm Fisher Investment Group, online at stormfisher.com.
See you soon.
Securities offered through Securities America, Inc., member FINRA, SIPC. Advisory services offered through Arbor Point Advisors, LLC. Storm Fisher, Arbor Point, and Securities America are separate entities.
Engagement rings, wedding bands, and big anniversary diamonds.
Welcome to Kessler's.
Traffic and weather. Let's get a look at the roads with Debbie Lozaga.
Okay, Julia. Uh-oh, problem on the Hone Bridge. Heading southbound over the Hone Bridge. Just past Car Ferry, we've got the two right lanes blocked with a crash. So that's backing things up across the span all the way back to Lincoln Memorial Drive. So heads up with that. Westbound 894, I haven't mentioned it in the last couple of reports, but it's pretty much the same as what we've been seeing all along. We've got delays out of the Mitchell all the way past the Loomis area to about 60th Street. They got that left lane blocked with some construction work being done on the medians there. Southbound on the bypass, slow from just south of Beloit Road down and around the Hale interchange to Forest Home. Eastbound's heavy from about 84th Street to the Stadium interchange. Westbound is going to be backed up out of the Marquette all the way to Mitchell Boulevard. And we still have this broken down vehicle on southbound 41 right about at Hampton Avenue. It is off on the left shoulder, and I'm seeing delays stretching back towards Appleton Avenue up to that point. So something to keep in mind. I'm Debbie Lozaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
Well, it's going to be a chilly night with lows about 24 degrees. If you're closer to the lake, inland temperatures about 18 degrees, up into the mid-30s tomorrow, but snow late, and it will affect your morning commute on Friday. We'll talk with Brian Nisnansky about that coming up in about 20 minutes. It's 33 degrees in Milwaukee at 516.
I'm so excited. It's American Chocolate Week. It's celebrated during the third full week of March every year. I didn't know that, but I thought, let's have someone on. The chocolate chisel, Elizabeth McCrimmon, joins us in studio. I love your place. I know exactly where you are in Port Washington. It's amazing.
Great.
You want to have the microphone a little closer to you? That'd be great.
Okay.
But listen, you brought a whole bunch of goodies for us.
I did.
I had Greg open it. Greg, what's your favorite so far?
Well, here's what I really appreciate about where chocolate has gone. Like, no longer is it just the basic hollow bunny that you get for Easter. You know what I mean? It's become artistic. Just some of what you brought, and Julia will hold it up for our cameras here if you're watching us on YouTube. It's artwork. It's beautiful. It's gorgeous. It looks hand-painted in some respects.
It is hand-painted. We have a professional chocolatier who makes all our truffles.
Oh, my goodness.
And she casts all those sculptures that you're enjoying right now.
Yeah, Julie just bit into the white chocolate mouse.
It's so good.
Yeah.
You know, for my wedding, I had a special chocolate area with, you know, some boutique looking. Look at this one. This one looks like it's a little piece of tea, right? Like mm-hmm. I'm sipping some tea.
Yes. Yeah. It's beautiful
so
artwork.
Beautiful.
And is all of this, is it molded? And then, you know, it's part of the handcrafting process, right?
If you're talking about the truffles... The truffles are hand cast, but they're small, but they're the biggest luxury item in our shop because they're the most labor intensive. They have to be decorated. Every cavity in the mold is hand polished with cotton balls before we can even start. Then they're decorated with the color, then they're shelled, then she puts in the ganache, and then she caps it. So it's this beautiful little melt-in-your-mouth center surrounded by a thin chocolate shell that protects the flavor.
This white chocolate's really melting in my mouth.
It's good. It's all cocoa butter. It's extraordinary chocolate. It's not the ordinary. It doesn't have some other white chocolates have 30 ingredients. Ours has 3.
I love that.
It's pure.
Oh, that's perfect. I love that. I go to Outpost for a specific kind of chocolate that's just like that. So if you're looking for something super healthy, this is the place to go. We are joined by Elizabeth McCrimmon, the chocolate chisel. So happy you're with us. You know, you opened store in 2009.
We did.
How has business been?
On Valentine's Day.
Oh, nice.
So So this last Valentine's Day was our 15-year birthday. We celebrated by giving away free chocolates and free ice cream because we're also an ice cream parlor. Everything we make is pure. The flavors in the truffles are the actual flavors. If it's matcha tea, we blend matcha tea right into the chocolate. If it's the coffee, we actually grind the coffee beans, a whole pound, into a coffee bean paste and then blend it with the chocolate to make the ganache, which is, it's so smooth. It's 0.02 microns or less particle size. It melts in your mouth like butter. It's in each specific truffle, of which we have 42 different flavors, is just like this with whatever flavor we have. If it's the raspberry heart, it's real raspberries blended into that.
Well, you can tell a lot of time, effort, and energy is put in into these handcrafted pieces. So how has your business evolved from when you opened to where you are, or where you are now? Because, you know, when I was a kid growing up, didn't really have stuff like this. It's become a very popular sort of thing, but only so few can do it the right way.
Yeah, well, we're artists. We combined our love of food and art, and we taught ourselves all these years, and we started out with one truffle case in the entire store, and we slowly built it up. Now we have a what we call a caramel case where everything's dipped, the dipped handmade caramel that we make in-house with chocolate or with turtles, which you have a box of turtles in that gift box I brought for you. The handmade butter toffee dipped, the coconut blended with chocolate. So there's coconut, we call them coconut hemis because they're hemispheres. And then we have built-in shelves around the entire store completely filled with chocolate products now. A whole line of barks. Anything you can imagine. Gingery pistachio, midnight cherry, which is tart dried Michigan cherries on dark chocolate.
What's fabulous. This one? It looks like it's a piece of a blue stone.
It looks
stone.
Like a gem. It looks like it looks like a rock you'd find somewhere.
Sapphire.
That's the Elvis Presley. It's a double layer truffle. It has banana and peanut butter.
Oh my goodness, it's so good. Everything is good.
Yeah.
You've had a million customers.
We have in 15 years. And I have to say, many of them might be repeat customers because we have such a loyal fan base. And I just went into our registers and counted all the transactions. And through the years, that's how many we've served. There's a lot of tourism in our town, and there's a lot of locals who are very supportive also.
Elizabeth, have you tried things that don't work? That just say, you know what, it sounded like a great idea. We mixed the flavors. We went that next step. We tried it, and wow, did that not work.
Well, we've gone through a lot of different barks that we no longer make. We had one called California Mudslide that really wasn't too popular. So if it doesn't sell, then we put it in what we call mystery grab bags.
Okay, there you go.
Fun!
And those sell like crazy. Everybody likes a mystery, and they know it's going to be chocolate and it's going to be delicious. So whatever, it might not be quite perfect or something doesn't sell. We put it right in those mystery grab bags and they fly out the door.
I ate the whole mouse and a teacup.
That was like 4 seconds.
I know.
You had that. And you ate Elvis as well.
A little bit of Elvis.
Okay,
Elvis
not
is
all
rich.
Of Elvis?
Yeah. Elvis is rich.
Understandable.
It takes 12,000 pounds of chocolate.
Yeah, and that sounds like a lot, but we're not a factory, so the big chocolate manufacturers think that we're small peanuts. But for us, we hand make it all, and it's a fabulous experience for our customers. It's like a flavor safari when they walk in and they see the shelves full with 400 different types of products, and they change throughout the seasons. Right now, we have 17 types of chocolate bunnies.
I appreciate organizations like yours and businesses like yours. You don't see that. And that's the best part of Wisconsin to me.
This
and
is
downtown
so cool,
Port Washington.
Right? I mean, it's family. There's heart. There's energy into it. It's the chocolate chisel in Port Washington. I'm going to sneak these pecan sea turtles away from Julia while she snacks on Elvis over there. Elizabeth McCrimmon is the owner and sales manager, the artistic director as well. You wear many hats at the Chocolate Chisel.
Yes,
thank you for
do.
Spending time with us today. It's always great to talk chocolate.
And everybody splurge. It's American Chocolate Week right now.
I'm so excited to be here and be with you. Thank you for having me here today.
Of course.
You bet.
Yeah.
524 on WTMJ.
It's John Merck here for the Freightert and the Medical College of Wisconsin Health Network. Precision medicine has become a growing trend in treating various conditions. It's often used for serious diseases like cancer. What is precision medicine and how's it used? To find out and to learn more about precision medicine, listen to my discussion with Dr. Huizi Chen, who specializes in lung cancer and rare cancers with the Freightert and the Medical College of Wisconsin Health Network. Hear that conversation and any of our past everyday health chats by visiting the features drop-down menu at WTMJ.com.
Hi, this is John Neal, CPA, founder of Right Choice Tax Resolution, and best-selling author on how to have less stress with the IRS. It's 2024 and an election year. The politicians are out there promising things they won't deliver. One thing is certain, taxes are what pays for those promises. The IRS collects those taxes, and man, can they be brutal. My latest book has advice on what to do to avoid trouble with the IRS. We help you file back tax returns, get liens released, set up payment plans, represent you in audits, and get penalties reduced or eliminated. Some recent clients we helped include getting a $40,000 tax bill reduced by $32,000, filing a 2020 tax return to get a $7,000 refund, and negotiating a payment plan for $250 a month on a $30,000 tax bill. Make the right choice. Go to rightchoicetax.us to book a call or in-person meeting right now. We know you want to take the first step in getting the IRS off your back so you can live again. That's rightchoicetax.us.
AccuNet Mortgage is an equal housing lender, NMLS ID 255368.
Steve and Ashley heard our radio ads over the years, and when it came time to buy their first home, clicked on the blue button. One of our senior loan consultants, Brad, sent them a credit-verified pre-approval the same day and then upgraded to a rock-solid, fully verified and guaranteed pre-approval shortly thereafter. They made a couple offers without success, and then Brad told them about AccuNet's new property-specific pre-approval, where we might be able to include those magic words, no appraisal required. When they wrote their next offer, several thousand dollars over asking to make sure someone else didn't end up sleeping in their dream home, their property-specific rock-solid guaranteed pre-approval included that most powerful phrase, no appraisal required, and the sellers picked Steve and Ashley's offer over several others. If you think all mortgage lenders and pre-approvals are the same, think again. Go with a local mortgage lender that has the tools and know-how to help you win and save money, too. Click on the blue button today at accunet.com.
ESPN Wisconsin's Mark Tosher here for my friends at Kohler Services. If you need a bath or shower remodel, turn to Kohler Services. Family owned for 150 years. Kohler is your Wisconsin manufacturer providing care for life. This month only, get $1,000 off your Luxtone shower and pay nothing until 2025. Visit KohlerServicesWI.com to request your free quote with fast, professional installation always included. Again, that's KohlerServicesWI.com.
Time for a WTMJ Annex Wealth Management market update. A strong day here for the Dow, especially closing 400 points up in the green today. 39,512 for the Dow to finish the day. Very strong. The NASDAQ up 202 points to close at 16,369. S&P 500 up 46 points today, closing at 5224. Annex Wealth Management, a fee-only fiduciary. For more information, visit annexwealth.com.
Whether you're a local who wants to enjoy a night out or you're planning to visit Milwaukee, enjoy an artfully stylish experience at St. Kate the Arts Hotel. The hotel is ideally located in the heart of the theater district in downtown Milwaukee. With deluxe accommodations, culinary creativity, on-site galleries, and nightly live music, you'll enjoy every element of your stay at St. Kate. Book special hotel packages with room rates starting as low as $129 a night. Learn more and book your stay at stkatearts.com.
Hey, WTMJ's John Merck here. When it comes to painting, don't do it yourself. Call the pros at your local neighborhood Serta Pro Painters. That's what we did. Serta Pro came out, gave us choices, walked us through the process. And then when they were there, it was quick. It was easy. Our home is beautiful. Excellent workmanship all the way around. It's Serta Pro Painters. Each Serta Pro Painters business is independently owned and operated right here in Wisconsin. Schedule your free estimate online at SertaPro.com. That's Serta with a C. When choosing a painting professional, the choice is simple. Choose happy. Choose two CertaPro painters.
You've heard about the thousands of patients finally getting relief from chronic joint pain thanks to QC Kinetics non-invasive treatments. And here's one who was determined to avoid surgery. Meet Vicky.
The orthopedic surgeon said, well, you're going to need knee replacement sooner rather than later. I kept hearing commercials about QC Kinetics and thought, well, I'm going to check them out first.
QC Kinetics has treated over 20,000 patients like Vicky around the country. People who were told they needed surgery but chose a more natural, less invasive approach that uses regenerative treatments to help heal and restore painful joints with no downtime.
If QC Kinetics had not been what I expected, I would have gone through with the surgery, but I got so much relief, am now pretty much pain-free that I don't have to have the surgery.
Before going under the knife, you need to check out QC Kinetics. The consultation is free. Call today.
Call QC Kinetics, 414-285-3474. That's 414-285-3474. 414-285-3474.
Traffic is sponsored by Design Exchange in Heartland and Pewaukee. Design Exchange is where discerning buyers with discriminating tastes come to find premium home decor on consignment at 25 to 40% off retail prices in Heartland and Pewaukee.
Wisconsin's Afternoon News on Wisconsin's radio station, News Radio WTMJ.
It's 5:30. I'm Greg Matzik. Your top story, guilty of election fraud.
I'm Julia Fellow, rolling out the red carpet for some top chefs.
I'm Debbie Lozaga, and some delays heading southbound over the Hone Bridge. We got an accident just about just south of Car Ferry Drive. Two right lanes are blocked because of this crash, so that is going to be affecting your ride there. So be careful with that. That's backing things up all the way back past Lincoln Memorial Drive. Also seeing delays southbound 43 from Hampton down past Keith and a little bit right through the Marquette interchange. Once you get off the high-rise bridge, you're good to go all the way down to the Mitchell. Northbound side is backed up out of the Marquette up past Keith, and westbound 94 slowing down from the Marquette all the way to Holly Road. And while you're out navigating the roads as quickly and safely as possible, if you do happen to see something we should know about, call the WTMJ Hall Volkswagen traffic tip line. It's 414-238-9329. I'm Debbie Lozaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
Increasing clouds tonight, chilly with a low of 24 near the lake, 18 inland, a high of 35 on Thursday, snow late, and it will impact your Friday commute. We'll talk to Niz coming up in about 5 minutes. 33 degrees in Milwaukee at 5:31. From the WTMJ Breaking Newsroom, the verdict is in.
We, the jury, find the defendant, Kimberly Zapata, guilty.
Former Milwaukee Election Commission Deputy Director Kimberly Zapata found guilty of misconduct in public office, a felony, and three misdemeanor counts of election fraud. Milwaukee Elections Commission Executive Director Claire Woodall on the stand.
She was frustrated that people like Representative Branchon continue to focus on what they consider election fraud issues that aren't real, and that this is a real potential security issue that she wanted to bring to her attention.
So what did Ms. Zapata tell you she did?
That she made up three voters.
Zapata will be sentenced on May 2nd.
Police need your help finding a person involved in a hit and run near 13th and Atkinson. This happened Tuesday afternoon just before 2 o'clock. A 61-year-old pedestrian was taken to the hospital. We're told that that person has life-threatening injuries after this crash. The vehicle that took off is described as a blue four-door 2006 to 2007 Honda Accord with a black front bumper and extensive damage to the windshield. Also look for damage to the hood and a missing driver's side headlamp. More details and photos of that car are on our website, WTMJ.com.
Well, more staffing coming to Waupun Correctional. The state prison is under scrutiny because of four inmate deaths since last year and increased lockdowns. Waupun Mayor Ron Bishop tells WTMJ's Spanning the State the prison staff is overworked.
The overtime that the men and women are working who are actually there is nuts, and we're beating them up and we're wearing them down. So we need to give the correctional officers some relief. We need to get them some help that'll help morale amongst the work staff, and I think that'll help morale amongst the inmates as well.
Bishop says help is on the way. More than 270 cadets recently graduated from the Department of Corrections' six-week training academy.
The effort to recall Assembly Speaker Robin Voss is losing steam, with the Racine County District Attorney's Office examining potentially forged signatures. Speaker Voss tells Wisconsin's Afternoon News the group that started the recall effort They just care too much about the past, he says.
They were worried about what happened in the 2020 election. I think we all know there were some challenges, but we are way beyond that now. They have gotten to the point where they can't let go of the past. We see that they had less than half of the signatures that they reported.
Speaker Voss says he will challenge the recall tomorrow.
A special event where women inspire the next generation of female leaders right here in Milwaukee.
The 14th annual Girls Day at City Hall taking place Wednesday. Founder of the event, Alderwoman Malele Coggs, tells WTMJ.
When I was elected in 2008, I was the only woman out of 15 members here at the council. And talking with other women who work at City Hall, we came up with Girls Day at City Hall.
High schooler Rakira tells WTMJ she dreams of working in public service as a teacher or lawyer.
I really wanted to highlight, understand what I would be going into as an adult. I want to take away confidence, empowerment, powerful speeches and quotes to help us as young women.
Julian Johnson, WTMJ News.
With Wisconsin as its backdrop, season 21 of Bravo reality series Top Chef premieres tonight. One of the show's 15 contestants is James Beard-nominated Milwaukee chef Dan Jacobs. Speaking to Wisconsin's Midday News, Jacobs describes the frantic nature of this competition.
There's no faking the clock. The clock is always your enemy. Especially for myself, with mobility issues, you have to kind of break yourself down into making sure you're accomplishing goals at certain times. So yeah, I mean, it's totally for real. It's breakneck.
Tonight's show airs at 8 o'clock on Bravo.
Time for a WTMJ sports update from the Gruber Law Office's One Call That's All sports desk. Bucks and Celtics tonight. No Giannis, however. Coverage gets underway at 6 o'clock in WTMJ. And the Brewers resume Cactus League play Thursday night in Arizona, opening day 1 week from tomorrow in New York against the Mets.
Setting unlimited WTMJ news time, 5:35.
This report sponsored by Mr. Holland's Heating and Air Conditioning. Visit MrHollandsHeatingAndAir.com.
I just can't say no when those sweet little scouts come around selling cookies. Which one's your favorite? I love the doozy doos and the tinfoils. That's what they're called, right? Hey, here's something else you can't turn down. A sweet new career with Mr. Holland's Home Services. We're currently adding to our growing roster of HVAC technicians, installers, electricians, and plumbers. You must be dependable, punctual, polite, and eager to learn. In other words, we're looking for some smart cookies to join our team. We'll set you up with a big box of benefits, along with tasty perks such as paid holidays, paid time off, 3-day weekends, and more. Plus, we'll sweeten the deal with a signing bonus. If only they gave a merit badge for home services. Oh well, that's the way the cookie crumbles. Start your journey as an HVAC tech, installer, electrician, or plumber with Mr. Holland's Home Services. Apply today at MrHollandsHomeServices.com/careers.
Wisconsin's Afternoon News on WTMJ.
Chilly conditions, it's going to get wet, snow's going to fall. How will it impact your Thursday night and Friday morning? Brian Niznanski, chief meteorologist from TMJ4, is with us. What are we looking at here, Niz? It looks like the models are starting to become more clear.
They are a little bit. There is still some inconsistency. It's not going to be a mega monster snowstorm, but it will be quite a bit. And that's, it's saying a lot because we haven't had much snow. It's been a little while, guys.
Are we looking at stuff that's just going to be real wet and heavy, but also likely melt because of the ground temperatures?
There will be some melting that goes on with this. In fact, I do think, our snow forecast would be quite a bit higher if it wasn't this time of year and we haven't had our warmest winter on record. And temperatures during the snowfall will likely be around freezing or a little bit above it. So that definitely already is a factor. But even with those factors, I think most of southeastern Wisconsin is looking at about 3 to 6 inches of very wet, heavy snowfall. Right now we're placing our southern spots south of Milwaukee, south of Waukesha, with lesser amounts, about 1 to 3 inches of really slushy snow there with more rain mixing in. But this still could shift a little bit, and I do think as confidence continues to grow, we may end up even adding a smaller, even heavier band within the area that's within 3 to 6. So stay tuned for those updates.
Can you give us an idea what you're seeing now in terms of timing?
Yep. Looks like moves in after midnight tomorrow night, so that's early Friday morning. I really think the brunt of the snowfall, the brunt of the accumulation, will be during the morning commute. I think it's going to be a mess Friday morning. I think the snow will come down at a heavy enough rate that it will offset the warm pavement temperatures, the warm ground temperatures, and we will get rapid accumulation on area roadways. I really do think Friday morning's commute looks pretty sloppy.
Looks like we're kind of in a rut here temperature-wise, too, Niz, of kind of mid to upper 30s for a few days.
Yeah, winter. I mean, this week has been more winter-like than almost all of February. So we definitely have taken a step back now that it's officially springtime. We do head into the weekend chilly, but then by Monday, it looks like we shoot back up to 55 degrees with rain likely. So there is still some spring weather in the forecast, but definitely more winter than what we've become used to.
Well, and pretty soon we'll be asking you about opening day. Hopefully no snow and more like the 50-degree temps you're talking about here.
You know that's all possible.
Or shut the roof. Exactly.
Exactly. Only if there was a roof over the tailgaters, right?
Can we all agree that was a good decision to have a roof
in
the stadium?
It's the best. There's just a drop of rain, and it's like, we need to shut this.
Absolutely.
Any time of the year, it's a state team that the people need to know that the game is going to go on.
No doubt about that. Niz, we appreciate your time, man. We'll be checking you out later tonight.
Thanks, Niz.
Yep, see you guys later.
DMJ4 meteorologist, chief meteorologist Brian Niznanski. Our conversation with Bucks forward Thanasis Antetokounmpo coming up right after this. It is 5:40 on WTMJ.
Come see Thanalysis live from Potawatomi Casino Hotel on Friday, March 22nd.
Hey, welcome to another Thanalysis show. And we are coming on in today's podcast.
Be there for the first ever live show for Thanasis as he's joined by his brother, none other than the Greek freak, Giannis Antetokounmpo.
I took off my shoes and I was like, go crazy, go hoop. That's all it was.
Get your tickets now at taliveshow.com. Thanalysis live at Potawatomi Casino Hotel on March 22nd. taliveshow.com.
All you have is one chance after an accident, one decision on who to call, one shot to get the help you need. Don't waste it on the one offer you get from your insurance company. Make the one call to Gruber Law Offices. It's the only one you'll need to make. Call us today. Gruber Law Offices. One call, that's all.
Hey, John Merck here for Annex Wealth Management. When it comes to your investment and retirement planning, a simple checklist might help. Is your financial advisor a fiduciary? How are they at tax planning? What about estate planning? Can they help make sure your legacy plan follows your wishes, or are they just trying to sell you something? There is a significant and real difference between financial advisors. That's why Annex Wealth Management urges you to know the difference. Annex is local, independent, and part of the community. And that matters. Their investment, retirement, tax, and estate planning teams, all based right here in Southeast Wisconsin. I know. I've used them all. Find out more about Annex every Saturday morning at 10 right here on WTMJ. There is a reason Money Talk, the Annex Wealth Management Show, is Wisconsin's longest-running financial radio show. Visit annexwealth.com. Click the Get Started button today. I did that years ago. Schedule your own appointment. That's Annex Wealth Management. Locations throughout Southeast Wisconsin or as close as your computer. It's Annex.
Hey, this is Steve Scafidi for Advil. I had some snoring issues that kept my wife up at night. That led to poor sleep and a lot of tired mornings on the radio, and nobody wants that, trust me. But it's simply, my nose wasn't working the way it should. I decided to go to Advil for a quick 30-minute visit, one of their great facilities, talk to a bunch of their doctors. They really put me at ease. After a really simple sleep study at home, in my own bed, they determined the root cause of my problem had to do with my sinuses and nasal passages in my breathing triangle. I didn't even know I had a breathing triangle until I went to see Advil. After a short procedure done in office, I'm back to breathing well, and my wife and I are both back to sleeping through the whole night. The best sleep we've ever had, that could be you. If you struggle with restless nights like I did, take the time to see how Advil can help. To find out how breathing well and sleeping well can make your life and your nights a whole lot better, go to AdventKnows.com, schedule an appointment today. Because Advil knows, when you breathe well, you live better.
Traffic is sponsored by Hall Mazda Milwaukee. Visit hallmazdamilwaukee.com.
Be our eyes on the road. Report accidents, slowdowns, and road conditions to the WTMJ Hall Volkswagen Traffic Tip Line at 414-238-9329.
Let's get a look at the roads with Debbie Lozaga.
All right. Well, it looks like they were able to reopen all the lanes on 794. For a while there, the right lane was just blocked. Looks like they were able to reopen the lanes as of a couple seconds ago. So be careful. Still going to be very heavy over the Hone Bridge all the way back to Lincoln Memorial Drive. Northbound 43 backing up out of the Kilbourne area all the way up to Keefe. Southbound slow just before Hampton all the way down to Keefe. It's opened up nicely heading through the Marquette. So if you do want to try and take that instead of the Hone Bridge to get to the south side, it's going to work. Westbound on 94, backed up from about 16th Street all the way to Mitchell Boulevard. The eastbound side, pretty heavy from 92nd Street all the way through the stadium. And then on the bypass, southbound from about Oklahoma Avenue down and around the Hale, all the way to about 51st Street, I'm seeing delays. The westbound side's backing up out of the Mitchell Interchange pretty much all the way to about 68th. I'm Debbie Lozaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
.544 on Wisconsin's Afternoon News. So glad you're with us this hump day. Hey, Buck's great. Thanasis is joining us on Wisconsin's Midday News. He talked about his upcoming live podcast at Pottawatomie Hotel and Casino happening this Friday. Tickets are still available. He's going to be talking to his brother Giannis live. It's just amazing. It's available. You can find it at WTMJ.com. A wonderful interview we had on Wisconsin's Midday News. Take a listen.
Happy to be joined by Thanasis and Tedekumbo. It's Thanalysis Live on Friday of this week, March 22nd. He and his brother, like you've never seen them before, on stage at Pottawatomie. Tickets available at taliveshow.com.
Hey, I love this. I just saw you just reached 100K downloads for your podcast. Congrats on that.
Thank you.
Why do you think people thoroughly enjoy, not just here in Milwaukee, but really around the world, people can listen to you? Why do you think they enjoy it so much?
I'd love to say that it's my voice, but I don't think that is. I don't think that's the case. I think it's another version of myself, but that I bring to the table, and it's who I interview as well, because it's different stories and narrative of people that you've only seen, you know, through social media or through or be celebrities. You know, I had Jake Paul on it. I've had guys, a lot of NBA guys. I've had different people. I've had fighters, Kamaru Usman. I've had like different people on the podcast that are, you know, sometimes they may be portrayed differently when it comes to their, you know, that field, but I wanted to just give a different feel for it. So,
well, you're off to an amazing start with it.
Thank you.
And it seems to be growing. A lot of these NBA podcasts are doing really, really well. And it's no surprise that you, with all your energy and charisma, would be very good at something like this. It seems to be natural for you.
No, thank you. It's hard. I'm trying to do it a kind of different way because, like, you know, you don't come to my podcast for the soundbite. You know, you don't come to my podcast for something that's going to, or gossip or like inside the locker room, stuff like that. You will get some of it, of course, but not in the extent that's what I do and that's what I'm known for. That's why people feel so comfortable to come to the podcast. That's why I get guys like Damian Lillard. Even though he's my teammate, people don't say this, but it doesn't matter if he's your teammate. Guys really don't want to do a podcast like that because they feel like I don't want to put myself out there for people to dissect and nitpick and say and get a, you know, get a soundbite, and all of a sudden I'm talked about for like 2-3 days. That affects people, you know, and how they. So I'm just trying to create this atmosphere of honest conversation, and mostly motivational, to be honest with you, because all of these people get like are in this position they are for a reason, and not, you know, nobody came and just dropped them from the sky. Like, oh, you know, it's more of like it's a process to it.
Who's that one get? You're like, ooh, I want to get this guy or this gal on my podcast.
Oh, that's a good question. It's so many. It's so many. Bliss is. I'm trying to get Elon Musk on my podcast.
That's a big one.
Which is a crazy thing to say, but I think not just because I would love to know a little bit about the future and the plans and what he's doing. Because people keep asking him about, you know, Twitter X, however you want to call it, and the different stuff he's doing now. I want to know what his view is and how he feels about the world. So because I'm very interested in this, because I'm a person who learns about the culture. And I want to know as well that for someone not being from here, coming here and trying to succeed, and what does it take to, and it takes another drive, obviously. I know this, I understand this, but in his world, it's kind of different. You know, it's different.
Would you go up into space with him?
Yes, 100%.
Yeah. That's in your view, right? You want to go to the moon?
Yeah, I mean, I do want to go to the moon, but so. By the way, I'm a guy who doesn't like. I don't bungee jump. I would never jump off a plane. I would never. You know, I'm very safe, kind of like that. But I feel like that's another. That's another multiverse for us as human. You know, it's another dimension for us. No, because. This is the, then you get to answer the questions that everybody asks. Are we alone in the universe? Are we, you know, what are we, what do we mean? You know, so it's another philosophy.
Speaking of alone in the universe, yeah. I bet Giannis felt like that when he was drafted and then in Milwaukee by himself, right? There's famous stories about Giannis sending money back to the family and then running to the then Bradley Center for a game, and somebody picked him up and drove him there.
Yeah.
You know, and I don't know if you guys have discussed this much, but what was it like for you as big brother watching little brother embark on this incredible journey in the unknown?
Scary. It was scary because, like, as older brother, you always want to be there. You always want to protect your brother, and you always want to set the tone. But very scary. But at the same time, I can show that I'm scared. I'm like, oh, look what's going on, and we're here. And we're sorry we don't know people, and language about it. We got to learn everything from the beginning, from scratch. But you can't show that emotion, you know, because if I do show that emotion, he looks up to me. So how is he going to feel if I'm saying, like, hey, I'm in Delaware and I'm trying to make it here and I'm scared and this, that, and I don't come out the house or I don't do this. So that is that aspect. But other than this, is the only mindset you have is, like, I want to see my family again and I have to succeed any way as possible. So
what do you, both of you, you and your brother Giannis, just love about Milwaukee? Because I'll tell you what, we love watching you guys. I mean, not just you balling out there in the court, but also just having fun and being good people. We appreciate that so much. So what do you appreciate about the people in Milwaukee?
First of all, the thing about I absolutely love about Milwaukee is the weather. The weather is...
You're trying to say it with a straight face.
No. No, jokes aside, I would say how hard Milwaukee works, how into the craft they are. You know, and you can tell by the team. You know, we're just a team for the past 5-6 years. We just do our job and go home. You know, we don't ask for a lot. We don't do a lot. And you see people who are even actually moving to Milwaukee trying to do the same. You know, just trying to work hard, create something for themselves, and just go home. But one of the other things is that people haven't seen, and I've seen it with my eyes, like how much Milwaukee has changed throughout the years. And I'm not saying real estate wise, you can see it. Obviously, the Pfizer, we used to play at the Bradley, the Pfizer was an empty parking lot, the Trade Hotel, like all these things being built. You know, we'll see totally different things in the next 5 years from now. And how people see sports and how the fan base has come out to support. But the most important thing is, it's not only with basketball. It's every, you know, from ESPN Milwaukee now, like doing all these things, from the radio shows, from people just saying, like, hey, we're gonna stay right here, and we're gonna grow our seeds in the place we are and not move, you know, not go to the bright lights, not say, okay, it's something better elsewhere. I'm gonna make this the place for me, you know. And I think that's the mindset we've had, and people have followed that with us. So that's the best part. And as well, obviously, I don't know. It's a weird love for Milwaukee. Not a weird love, because they ask me, where are you from the States? When you're from the States, where are you from? I just go to Milwaukee, you know? And in the beginning, when people in Greece would ask me, like, where's Milwaukee? I'd be like, oh, yeah, you know, I'd explain. But when people in the U.S. ask me, where's Milwaukee? I'm like, no, come on. You've never been in the Midwest, or you've never been in Chicago and stuff like this. And actually, and in the past 4 years, I actually get offended nowadays.
You're
no,
one
seriously.
Of us.
Seriously.
You're one of us now.
Seriously.
I
get offended. And one of the things that people would never tell you is when you start.